Your content isn't even art, Jim. Your content isn't even artistic.
You were picking on a guy weaker than you, weren't you, Jim?
I might say it's because you're a loser who's playing to an audience of children.
I'd like to join your posse, boys, but first I'm gonna sing a little song.
He's the very best. He's the rubiest, coolest cowboy in the
You have a bully cabal that you have created.
A bully cabal.
Outer heaven.
What else would you call it?
I'd call it the sweet spot. We spread hugs and love across the internet.
Bullshit. You know that's not true. You know what you do.
What am I? Name the bully. No. Name the bully for a thing. Bully Hunter will help you.
You don't want to build a wall. Instead, you want to use a military approach and run sorties over drug cartels.
Sure, and work with Mexico to rebuild its country. Yeah, sure. If we're going to invest money into something, why not in making Mexico better so that a bunch of fucking people don't run away from that country into ours?
Okay. That's brilliant.
This is like the ultimate condescending argument from somebody that's never ever been in a shitty position in their entire life. Like, I can't even believe
that
somebody.
What the fuck you're talking about.
I don't. You can't. Either that, or you lack zero empathy or have zero intelligence.
I'm not part of your lying, doxing, harassing teenage fan club. I'm someone doing something in real life.
And I have an army of mercenary children wreaking havoc on web forums from here to hell and back.
You understand I'm a person, don't you? Do you think white people act like this? White people are meant to be polite and respectful to one another, and you guys can't even act like white people. It's really, like, amazing to me.
Jim, it's people like you that need to get a bullet to the head, because you're promoting hatred, bigotry.
Oh, is it bigotry against pedophiles? Pedophobia. It's pedophobia.
You're low rent, low IQ trash. I was 100% right to call you a religious bigot. It's what you and your fans are.
But as a white person who is male, you're never told that there's anything you can do. You have no idea what it's like to be told you're not supposed to do that. That's not the kind of job for you, because the sky is the fucking limit.
What I was saying was that there's this YouTuber that I admire very much, that I used to admire, but I realized that his game is to punch down. But he always mocks people who are weak, who are small. I can't stand the big guy who bullies me or tries to bully me.
There is a toxicity that has developed in among gamers.
Okay.
All right? It is actually, it feels somewhat fascist in the way it's working.
That's amazing. Okay, hold on. Here we go.
Hey kids, it's time to have fun.
Call me Jerry. Friends are my
best who ever edited this video. That was the perfect ending to it. I'll be honest with you. By buying a goddamn American capitalist hat. Oh, gotta use that USA dollars to do it. Where are you gonna do that, you ask? Well, you don't really ask, but I'm gonna show you anyway. Fuck you. I'm gonna show you anyway. Oh, look at those hats. Quality fucking hats, ladies and gentlemen. Wear it around town, it looks fancy. Buy a hat for your hat. Buy a hat for your hat. Buy a hat for your hat. Quality fucking hats, ladies and gentlemen. Buy a hat for your hat. Buy a hat for your hat. Wear it around town, it's fancy. Buy a hat for your hat. When I'm sad, pay me. It's the only cure, really. When you're very sad, you need to pay me money. You gotta buy my fucking hats. Alright, that's the only way you're gonna teach these communists their fucking place. These lemon-loving motherfuckers. It's by buying a goddamn American capitalist hat. Oh, gotta use that USA dollars to do it. Buy a hat for your hat. Quality fucking hats, ladies and gentlemen. Buy a hat for your hat. Wear it around town, it looks fancy. Buy a hat for your hat. Love the red, white, and blue. Love my apple pie and baseball. Sometimes I just look at the Statue of Liberty. It's so goddamn beautiful. Oh, that is good stuff. You know what? Buy a hat for your hat. Buy a hat for your hat. You know what? Buy a hat for your hat. To sell you beautiful fucking hats. We all love Jim's hats. Let me move a little bit. Over on Shopify. Metokur.myshopify.com. Buy the finest hats available. You gotta do this. You're gonna do that over at my store. Buy my hats. Teach the communists a lesson. Fuck the lemon. Buy a hat. You gotta do this. Buy my hats. Gotta do this. Buy my hat. You know what? Buy a hat for your hat. Gotta do this. Buy my hat. Gotta do this. Buy a hat for your hat. Quality. Buy my hat. Gotta do this. Buy a hat for your hat. Gotta do this. Buy my hat. Gotta do this. Buy a hat for your hat. Oh. Holy shit! Oh, what a fucking beautiful ending to this. Oh God, let me get a cigarette for this one. Oh my God, Daddy returned from the store. Oh, he said he was gonna go get milk and smokes and he was gone forever, but now he's back. Happy Father's Day. Oh, what a wonderful occasion. What a wonderful occasion. Look at those happy little puddings. There's Dad. That's about right.
That's about the look of a man that has to have another man feed his children SpaghettiOs. It's a rough day. Oh, let me end this poll. Buy a hat for your hat? Well, it looks like it's overwhelmingly 100% yes. Fantastic. I'm glad. I'm glad everybody's in complete agreement about this. We've got a fun little show today. A fun little stream going over internet fathers. Oh, everybody loves them. Everybody loves a good internet dad. And there are plenty of stories out there to follow. Two in particular, I'm going to be kind of hyper-focused on. Talk about a few other things as well. And I'd be remiss if I didn't remind you all to go buy my merchandise, because I am a shill at the end of the day. And look at all those new items available. Oh my God. How fantastic. And as I'm shilling, unrepentantly so, telling you to buy mugs and hats and shirts. By the way, somebody mentioned this, and I can't fucking believe I didn't hone in on it when I did the Ricada stream. And I put his face on a mug, and they're like, why didn't you say buy a mug for your mug or get a mug of your mug? Great marketing. Completely fucking dropped the ball on it. Not even think. I'm so focused on hats, I let that marketing opportunity just slip through my fingers. But we had a little issue earlier with Ko-Fi for some reason. I don't know if somebody's trying to kneecap me or what. But for some reason, for about an hour or two, nobody could donate. Now, I think I've unfucked it, and I have a suspicion there might be an oinking madman behind this, but it should be fixed. I don't know. The only way we can test it out, Chad, is if you all donate. I mean, let's make sure that Ko-Fi link works. Let's make sure it works. Don't let the pig win. Don't let him win, folks. Actually, I'm not sure really what happened, but something did. All of a sudden, all the money got turned off. I don't know what the fuck, how you fuck up Ko-Fi. I somehow did it, but it should be unfucked. Please don't make me have to go to eBay like Teddy. I don't want to sell Pretty Princess Disney playsets and bootleg Little Mermaid German versions for 79 cents a piece, okay? I don't want that to be my fucking future. Please make sure that Ko-Fi link works, folks. Let's all make sure that Ko-Fi link works so Jim doesn't have to go to eBay and sell Pretty Princess shit. It's a little scary. Nobody wants to make their fucking living on you. Oh, Teddy, Jesus. Someday I'll get into your story. That'll be a fun one. That'll be a fun one, Teddy. Okay, let me make sure I've got everything lined up here. Have I hoarded myself out enough, Chad? Have we done enough? I played the intro thing. I've got the merch up on screen. I could do like the Kino Casino and start screaming sub train, but there's no subs over here. I can't. Like, I got nothing. I got. There's no sub trains choo-chooing over here. I'm sorry, folks. No, instead, we're celebrating Father's Day.
Who is your daddy and what does he do?
That's right. Who is your daddy and what does he do? Now, I know, when I talk about internet fathers, you have people come to mind immediately. I know there are things that pop up. How could they not? One person in particular I know, everybody's like, oh, he's going to have to mention him. There's no way he can't not mention him. So let me give this little man his little bit of attention, because we have more funny, entertaining things to get to. But I will mention a contender. Maybe I'll do a poll at the end, and you can all choose which of these fathers are the best father on the internet. So let's start it off with what is obviously going to get mentioned for at least a few minutes. Ethan Ralph, the Rage Pig himself. Oh, I love my son. I love my, help me do my $1,300 fundraiser. I'm going to just zanny myself out. And, oh, God, I'm tired. Oh, I'm tired. Those are bug bites on my daughter. Let me call her a little bitch. Good old Ethan. Dad of the Year contender? Sure, why not? Let's throw his name into the ring. Now, I buried this motherfucker already on a stream. There's really not much to go over. I think you're all familiar with him and his shenanigans. And that's your minute, Rage Piggy. That's your full minute of attention. I hope that sustains you for the next fucking half a year. I hope that funds your tortas for the next 6 months. Oh, he's a hollering now. Oh, so mad. Oh, I'm a piggy. Oh,
Oh, Ralph, you silly fucker. You know, I could go into depth, but you know he's a terrible father. Jesus Christ. I had to shame the man into paying child support. That's a true story, by the way. Ethan Ralph refused to pay child support until I made merchandise making fun of him. I used to sell a shirt that said, I spent more money on this shirt than Ethan did his son. And then all of a sudden he wants to pay child support. That's the kind of caliber of dad we're talking about. I could go into the drinking and the drug use and the abuse and all that. Everybody fucking knows it. Everybody fucking knows it. Now we want to move on to the more interesting shit. The newer stuff. The stuff we haven't got over before. The thing that really inspired this particular stream was somebody by the name of Thorpe. Benjamin Thorpe. Now, I'm not sure if you're very familiar with him. I'm not super familiar with him. I've encountered him a bit here and there. But even looking into just a little bit of it, it's a bit of a wild story. So let's say contestant. We're not even going to count Ralph. Sure, he's got four tits, but he's not really a full person. So we can't call him contender number one. Instead, we're going to start with Ben Thorpe. He's contender number one. Let me pull the sexy man up. Look at that. Is that not the most fuckable individual you've ever seen? Does that not ooze sex appeal to you? Now, you're about to hear a bit of a wild story. There's a lot to this gentleman. Way more than I could cover. There are fucking video documentaries on him that run 3-4 hours long on YouTube. If you're interested, you can find them by multiple fucking channels. But I put together a nice little like collage, a summary of what makes him a fantastic father. What makes him daddy of the year. And I think you're all going to really, really enjoy it. I think you're going to really enjoy what makes him a daddy of the year. Oh, boy. Let's see how far we can push the limits on YouTube. Now, let me put a trigger warning up here. We're going to be talking about some daddy on daughter action. I know, it's weird talking about the subject of incest without Destiny running in to get into the debate. But we're going to be going over it. Oh, somebody's fucking their daughter. Don't tell Vito about this stream. He'll get his pants off. We'll never get rid of him. Okay. Let's get these clips lined up. It's a little Vito joke. it's a tiny little Vito joke there. Let me light a cigarette. Because, whew, am I going to need it. Now, what brought Ben to my attention? Well, Ben has had a rough couple of months. I think this goes back, I would say, until, was it March or April when this really popped off? Now, he's been doing goofy shit on the internet for a while. You've probably seen him. Maybe you've seen him pop up here and there. He's been on Ralph's show. He's been on other people's shows. People have done videos about him. He's got a sordid history. But really what brought him to my attention was the numerous arrests. And we're going to talk about why he got arrested. But let's start at the beginning, because that's where else are you going to begin a story? Let's start with the assault. Uh-oh. Dial 911. There's an assault going on.
You look like you're going to cry, and then you hold back because you're so afraid of daddy doing something to you.
You're so afraid of daddy doing something to you. Now, that's Ben. That would be Ben laying on his bed. And that would be his daughter, who he just mule kicked. Let's back it up. Daddy's coming for you.
Cry, and then you hold back because you're so afraid of daddy doing something to you. Right? Uh-oh.
No, that's literally not why.
All bullshit all the time.
She's a little stunned right now. I mean, I guess any little girl would be if daddy mule kicked them on the bed. Oh, and we'll get to why they're on a bed together on their little trip cross country. And, oh God, what a fucked up story. So yeah, the daddy mule kicks. She gets a little fucked up over it.
That's literally not why. I'm sorry. Oh my God. I don't mean to do this.
I've God. Daddy, I'm so sorry that I let you kick me like a mule. Oh, let me scratch. Oh, I love the psycho reaction. That's always good. You could tell there's some deep-seated fucking trauma here.
Not why.
Watch this just spaz out. Oh, there's a little bit of trauma. Chat, is there a little bit of trauma going on here? I think there might be a tiny bit of little trauma, a little bit of damage, maybe. I think there might be a little bit of damage.
I'm sorry. Oh, my God. I don't mean to do this.
So that would be like, that's classic Darvo, right? Like, he literally mule kicks this chick, and, like, she's apologizing for it. He's like, you fucked up. So how could you make Daddy hit you? How could you? God, oh, what a worthless daughter this girl is. She made Daddy hit her. You should apologize. Apologize, right? Clean the carpet. Yeah. Oh, I'm so upset. So our Father of the Year contestant, Ben, mule kicks his daughter. And I believe this is what set the chain of events into place. I could be wrong. But, of course, it leads to arrest number one. Yes, that's right. There are multiple arrests coming up. So let's take a look at arrest number one.
Joke for the stream.
Now, this happened almost immediately. If I'm remembering this right, if I've got the timeline chronology right, I don't know. I could be wrong. But she gets mule kicked and cries and says she's a fuck up. And then here we are. We got another stream started up as the popo show up. And they're like, hey, did you know it's illegal to kick people? You can't really assault people on camera. It's kind of this thing called a crime.
Can I even see him?
Is it raining where you live? What the fuck?
Let's be quiet right now.
Yeah, so here's the story, officer. My dumb fucking daughter hurt my foot when I kicked her. Can we put her in jail? All right, I stubbed my toe kicking this bitch. I would really appreciate it if we could maybe file some charges here, officer. I don't think it worked out very well for him because they put his ass in cuffs. All the childhood trauma lost like tears in the rain. I like how she cleans off the lens just so she can cry a little harder. And she's still apologizing. Gets kicked by her father. Spazzes out on stream. Now she's freaking out because Daddy's getting arrested.
Don't worry, Grace.
I love this, by the way. I see people in chat saying, oh, this is some dark shit, Jim. This is some Silent Hill stuff. This poor kid. Oh, my God, this poor girl. We haven't even got to the dark part yet. All you've seen is a mule kick and her crying and freaking out a little bit. I know that you can sense it, chat. You can feel it in the air. It's electric. You know, we all know watching this that there's some damage to this girl. And I don't mean from the kick. There's some shit going on. But wait till you find out what kind of damage. Well, we're getting to some really dark shit.
Let me just pause a second, Grace. What you need to do? Are you still there? Okay. Yeah.
I should also mention half of these fucking streams, like the arrest streams and other things, they're like done in these group calls. So you'll hear people pop on occasionally, and you're like, "Who the fuck is that?" I don't know who they are. Let's just ignore who they are. We'll focus on the video itself. Okay, miss, if you can put your hands behind your back, you're getting arrested for being a dumb bitch in the first degree. This is a man's world, and when Daddy hits you, you're supposed to take it. I know that sounds completely fucked up, but you're under arrest, Grace. All right, first, you got molested. That's your fault. Secondly, you got kicked. That is also your fault. Miss, you're going to jail for a long time. Can you put the camera down? No, of course not. Of course not. That would be ludicrous. But of course, this is a crazy fucking story, and it's kind of like that. Wait till you see.
Okay.
Based on like whatever you guys had going on in your live stream today, somebody reported it, and it was like a kicking you. Right. So in Rhode Island, that's considered domestic assault, like domestic violence, simple assault. All right. I understand you have your YouTube podcast and everything like that, whatever you guys do, but essentially.
But it was a joke, and I don't have any problem with what happened.
Listen, miss, I understand you're one of those YouTubers. I've seen YouTubers before. You're a bunch of fucking weirdos, to be honest with you, but by God, we still have to arrest him for kicking you like a mule, miss. I love how the cops like try to subtly explain it. Like, yeah, no, I get it. You're YouTubers. Complete fucking freaks of the earth. I've seen YouTubers. There's like this guy called I Am Alex. Like, he's doing these little T-Rex spasms. I saw that. That was a recent thing, miss. All right, threatened to brick his girlfriend or something, smash her head against the wall. I get it. You're all fucking screwed up people. But I work a regular job. Because I got this badge on my shirt, I've got to haul Daddy off to prison. And it's all your fault. I hope that doesn't upset you, but it's your fault.
Hands are tied, okay? So what's going to happen is he's going to go to the station. He's going to be processed. He's going to be booked and everything like that. I know it's a cash bail for $50. I don't know if you drive or anything like that.
Yeah.
So, like I said,
wait, what did he say there?
He said the cash bill is $50.
The bond is $50?
I went there. They did not say that.
What did they say?
They said it could be up to $10,000.
So, that's arrest number one. Now, what happens? He gets arrested. Now, if I remember vaguely from when this first happened, and again, it's just me watching bits and pieces of it. It didn't really catch my attention until we get more arrests into this. But it was like, was it $50? Was it $10,000? Was it $1,000? The point is, he posted bond. He got out. He was able to bail himself out, or he got out somehow, released on his own recognizance. Maybe the judge was like, dude, that was you should play football, man. That was a field goal worthy kick right into her fucking sternum. And I'm just going to let you walk out of the jail. I don't know exactly, but he got out. Now, arrest number two, a bit problematic. A little bit of a difficulty here. There is footage of it, but the only footage I could really find of it was on somebody else's podcast where they talk over the entirety of it. But basically, a no contact order was put into place. He gets arrested for simple assault, from my understanding. He bails out. The judge, the law, basically say, hey, you two can't be near each other while these criminal proceedings are going on. If you violate this no contact order, whatever it is, restraining order, we're going to bring you back into jail. Maybe it's a bond condition. Who knows? And so arrest number two happens. And again, there was a full video, 40 minutes long, of this happening from body cam footage. It got privated. And there is footage. But I got a 10-second snippet to give you a feel of it. Just a feel of it. This is arrest number two.
Are you still living on... So you still living in Warren now, Ben? In Warren?
Yeah.
Yes and no?
Yeah. So they find out, and I believe it's because, and this is probably the most brilliant thing. Here's really smart thinking. You know, noggin jogging level shit. When you break the law, always make sure to record yourself and live stream it. It's a smart decision to do. When you assault your daughter and the police arrest you and you bail out, make sure that you do multiple streams where you both can be seen and heard together. So the police have ample evidence when fucking A-logs call them to come and arrest you at every location you go to. So here come the cops, and I believe that's arrest number two. I'm pretty sure they didn't just cite him. I'm pretty sure they hauled his ass back in. Somehow, he finagles his way through this one. So he assaults his daughter, gets arrested, bails out, seen with her during a no-contact order, somehow finagles his way out again. Whatever county they live in must love watching women get beat. It must be a fucking pastime. It's like the Olympics for them. This is a fucking team sport. You got the judge, the prosecutor, just cheering them on with foam hands and shit. Kick that bitch. Kick her good. I'm not exactly sure, but somehow he got out. Somehow he found his way out. Which leads us into what got my attention. So, I mean, that's kind of the buildup, right? You got the assault, you've got a couple of arrests, but we're going to go for the trifecta, a hat trick in hockey, if you will, for arrest number three. And again, when you're committing a crime, please make sure that you film it and that everybody knows that you're violating a no-contact order.
one of the cops or Chatter's fucking with her.
Now, the fun part about this, we've got multiple camera angles too. We'll look at a second camera angle of this happening. Is I believe she lied to the cops because they're like in a, it's like an SNL skit. You ever see in a van down by the river? That's basically what's going on here. They have literally hid in the woods in the world's shittiest RV. But so this is a brilliant plan. Can one of the Thorpes answer me? Like what was the brilliant plan here? You're going to hide in the fucking woods so you can be together and the cops can't fuck with you. But then you're going to live stream the location so they know that you're together and the cops can come fuck with you. Doesn't that, you must be the world's worst hide and seek players that have ever existed. You were like the kids nobody wanted on their team because you just stand in the middle of the road screaming. That's not really how you hide. Ben and Grace, why are you in the street screaming? This is hide and seek. That's not how the game is played.
Can I call in real quick? They're talking to each other. Cops looked inside of Jay-Z and said, the ghetto! The ghetto. They're putting the dog back.
Hey, Grace. Hey. Just so we can get out of here, okay?
Okay, miss. This is like the third time we've been called down here. I'm starting to get actually a little angry myself. Now, I know that your father mule kicked you, but I've got shit to do. We've got like burglars and rapists and killers and shit. I'm going to mule kick you, Grace. Like, yeah, really, I've reached my limit with your shit. All right, it's going to be more than daddy. I've got a taser and a baton. And this is the third fucking time I've had to track you horny little idiots down in the woods. Alright? I'm not getting paid enough for this shit, Grace.
And we can put this to rest. Can you unlock the van for us? We're gonna look in the van. If he's not there, we're leaving for the night. We're not gonna be here all night. Both our dogs show no interest in the woods, so we're not gonna sit here all day. So
I don't wanna answer any more questions without ensuring present.
No, all I'm saying is, can you just open up your dad's car so we can look inside? Make sure he's not there. If he's not there, we're out of here.
I'm not going to answer any questions without an attorney
present.
Okay. Oh, great, Bob. We got a sovereign citizen. Jesus fucking Christ. Oh, maybe the mule kick made her retarded. Next, she's going to be talking about land boats, Articles of Confederation. Just open the fucking door, Grace.
They got a drone. That's the drone. That's the drone. That's the drone.
We have you surrounded. We're not going anywhere. We're going to force entry if you don't come out.
They said they're going to break the window.
But did you think they were going to magic their way through the door, Grace? The cop asked you, could you open the door for us? It's locked. You're like, I don't want to answer any questions without an attorney. Then she's got that surprised squirrel look on her face like, they're going to break the window. Yeah, they're going to break the window. They're going to have SWAT come down there with a bulldozer and fucking crunch this thing in half. It's going to be like a little Ben Sardine popping out, Grace. Maybe just open the fucking door.
There's all of them right there. Don't we just get a warrant for this?
Do they need a warrant? The dude, Grace, seriously, he's been arrested, what is this, a fucking assault, and then violating the no restraint order, and now potentially doing it aside. I don't think they need a warrant. I think at this point, I mean, remember, you're live streaming this in the forest. And this fucking setting's like a horror movie. I feel like I'm on the set of a horror movie, like fucking Jason Voorhees is going to come around a tree and just machete people. Like, what? This is the darkest fucking place they could park? So are they filming the new fucking Saw movie out here? I don't, like, what the fuck? Let's go camp in the spookiest place possible for our incest fiasco. What the fuck?
There's the drone.
It went through the window.
I hear something. I don't know if it's a radio.
I like to imagine that Ben is in there because he's like a tall dude. He's like 6'7". He's like an ogre. The guy's fucking retardedly tall. He's a big dude. I like to imagine he's trying to hide behind like one of the back seats as they have their floodlights right on him. Like, we can see you, you know. I'm looking right at you, and he's like, I'm invisible. It's like a little kid logic. If I can't see you, you can't see me. I'm invisible. I'm totally hidden in here, 6'7", crouching behind the world's smallest chair with your floodlight on me. You can't find me.
Yeah, mirror.
He's right there. Yeah, he's definitely in there.
He's in there.
He's right there. The mirror is gone. You can't see anything.
Come out now!
I can't
open it.
Benjamin, get out!
Come on,
Benjamin.
Oh, he's there. Hey, Shrek, we can see your fucking giant ass in there. 10-4, buddy. I see you, Shrek. You're not hiding in this swamp very well. There's no donkey coming to sing a musical number. We're putting you in chains, okay, old boy? Now, how about you hobble your green ass the fuck on out of here before I get my mace?
No, you don't have to.
Back up.
You have to open the bathroom door in order for him to get out. You have to open the bathroom door.
Turn him out.
You made this so much harder on yourself, my man. Thanks for lying, but we got him.
Cop. Hey, thanks a lot, you dumb bitch. Yeah, we saw the fucking giant man living in your van. Wasn't hard to spot him. His head is literally poking the metal out. The aluminum's bent around it. He is 19 feet tall. What were you trying to hide?
Yeah, just an hour and a half away, right? You called it. Yeah. Yeah, I thought I could hear muffled. Yeah. I knew right when the dogs had no interest in going down there.
How far he's in custody, all crazy can stand down.
We caught the ogre. 10-4. Tell SWAT to return to base. Ogre is in custody.
That's a tight fit.
The pants are going down.
No, when you walk out, I'll pick him up. Don't worry about it. I'll pull him up.
Now that's interesting. So he gets arrested in a van in the woods with his daughter. And the first thing he says to the cops after they get in there is, my pants are falling down. My pants, I can't get my pants on. Why would there be a pantsless ogre in a van with a young girl in the woods? I don't know. Let's keep watching.
Do you have a cell phone or anything like that your daughter can get for you? So you can bring that? You can bring that phone for you if you want.
I don't care.
You're going to be brought to court tomorrow.
Yeah, that's all. What am I doing?
I told you, look at the size of this guy. Why were you trying to hide in the van? Your head literally scrapes aluminum. Look at the size of you, motherfucker. Where were you hiding? There's nowhere to hide. You're enormous. Did you think they weren't going to spot you?
RO violation. Because she has an RO against you. Yeah, it's in the system. Yeah, we confirmed it with Rhode Island. Yeah.
Give me the note, Connor.
It says, it's still a no contact, it's still the same thing, Massachusetts, so.
I'm sorry, Dad.
God, it would have been Kino if, when she said, I'm sorry, Dad, if he just fucking broke free of the police and mule kicked her right in the chest. It's your fault, you fucking slut. You did it again, Gracie. Just full-on cops episode, meth strength, ogre rage. Brick, look at those cops, are like 3 feet tall, just tosses them aside like little Lego bricks, and just punts her ass across the forest in a furious rage. It's your fault, Gracie.
No weapons on
it.
No. You just want your cell phone?
Just personally.
Yeah, I'm impressed.
I love you, Dad. I'm sorry they're doing this.
I have shoes.
Where you shoot that?
It's fine. Just take me out.
Yeah, I just want to check
you. I know you can't say anything, but I really love you. I'm really sorry this is happening.
Yeah, I'm so sorry this is happening. God, sorry every time you get arrested, I've got a camera in your face. Sorry, live stream every time we try to secretly do this and fuck it up repeatedly. Sorry about that.
I love you. I'm sorry.
I'm so sorry. You kicked me.
Probably.
But my car's right behind.
It's the biggest one.
How did I violate the no contact?
Are you having contact right now?
How did you violate the no contact order? Well, sir, the woman that you fucking mule kicked happens to be literally standing right next to you screaming, I love you, daddy. That might be how you violated the no-contact order, sir.
Back with her right now?
No.
She's right here, right? She's right with you. That's a pretty solid contact,
and we have
right?
numerous witnesses saying
you contact her?
We're not going to talk about it.
Let's go.
It's fine. You can unlawfully arrest me.
Okay. Head this way.
This is total bullshit. It's unlawful. Can you prove that I've had contact with her? Sir, she's standing literally right next to you. I don't know who that woman is. I've never seen her before. Sir, your boot print is tattooed on her chest. I don't know what you... We have forensic running it right now, sir. I'm pretty sure it's going to match your footprint. I've never seen this girl in my life. Officer, I thought this was America. I thought this was land of the free. Let me out of these cuffs. I'm going to kick that bitch. Which bitch would that be, sir? You're right. I don't know who that bitch is. She's just fucking strange. I'm just camping in the woods. Went out to fish a little bit, and this strange woman approached me. Started calling me daddy. I don't know who the fuck she is. I don't know who the fuck this is. Okay, so this got my attention, right? This is arrest number 3. I was going to show you the second angle. I think you get it. So, commits assault, gets arrested once, goes to jail, bonds out, gets arrested twice or apprehended by the cops twice, snakes out of it. Third time, gets arrested, and I think he's out again, right? We've seen him in chat. Wasn't he in chat saying they're doing a stream right now, which I'm sure is going to lead to great consequences. More fantastic outcomes. So, what's the backstory here, right? Because now I'm sure you're interested. Okay, this is a little weird. Dad mule kicks his daughter, gets arrested 3 times because of it. They're hiding in the woods in a van together. Where mom? You know, where's mom? Where's other family, siblings, and relatives? What the fuck is going on here? So I tried to put together a little snippet. Again, I'd recommend go look it up yourself. There's like hours of this shit. People have done documentaries and interviews, and you can go look it all up. But I took a few things, some testimonies, some stories, a little bit of the family dynamic, and just put it together because we're talking about contestant number 1 for Father of the Year on Father's Day. So let's go into what I like to lovingly call the, what did I title this? Oh, the blowjob story. Oh, hello darkness, my old friend.
How old was Grace when you had her perform fellatio on a bottle of beer that was between your legs for her mother?
Now, wait, did that happen?
Okay, I will answer that question.
Ben, did
you
that
cannot
happen?
Perform fellatio on a bottle of beer, retard.
Okay, all right. Was she...
Seems like a coke.
Now, fellatio is sucking a dick. You can simulate fellatio on a bottle of beer.
Now, wait, Ben.
Which I'm
now,
sure
Ben,
you do
wait,
on a night
hold
of
Hold on, Ben. Wait. Grossly, hold on. Wait. Ben, did that happen? Did she simulate fellatio on a bottle of
yes.
beer?
Yes.
So there I was, just watching a football game, and I had a Budweiser in between my lap, and I said, hey, daughter. She didn't pay attention, so I mule kicked the bitch, and then she paid attention. I said, hey, daughter, unless you want another mule kick, daddy wants you to suck on his Budweiser. Mommy's watching. Come suck on daddy's Budweiser. Come suck. Yeah, maybe you're confused. Did that happen was the question. Was she sucking a beer bottle in your crotch?
What's she doing?
Beer?
Now, wait, Ben.
Which I'm
now,
sure
Ben.
You do on a night
hold on,
baby.
Ben. Wait. Grossly, hold on. Wait. Ben, did that happen? Did she simulate fellatio on a bottle?
Yes.
Of okay.
Yes.
Now.
Oh, okay. That happened in the prior location. Right. Yes.
Yikes.
Okay. Now, Grossly.
I didn't tell her. We have to be careful of language. I did not have her perform or simulate fellatio on a bottle
stop?
Of
did you
beer.
Say, hey, stop this, or was it like, was it just a funny joke?
I am the victim here. I did not have her perform this. She forced it upon me. I can't get away from this girl, okay? Every time I have a beer bottle in my lap, it's like she's like, she thinks I'm a shark. She acts like a lamprey. She's like a leech thing. She's sucking blood. I don't know what the fuck's going on.
Joke or what? Like, I mean.
She? No, she did. I can explain that. She did this. Now, okay, this didn't come out. I voluntarily said this story to help give people some context.
Yeah.
Grace enthusiastically did this because she was so tired of her mother insinuating that this was going on. So she was just like, okay, so let's just play out your fantasy, which we had heard a number of times, in which she admitted that she masturbated fantasizing about my daughter and me having coital sex, like full-on penetrative sex.
So let's bring you up to speed on the Thorpes here. You know, I think this is a situation we've all been in, chat, really. I mean, honestly. Every Thanksgiving, it's just something that happens. There you are, eating dinner with your parents, when your mom starts furiously masturbating at the thought of you having sex with your father. And your dad's like, Jesus, let's give the bitch something to look at. And he pulls out a beer can, a beer bottle, sticks it in between his legs, and he just kind of dangles it at you. He's like, dinner time. And you run over there. You're eager because you love your mother. And you understand that's how Thanksgivings are celebrated. All right? This is normal behavior. Now, that was a very short snippet talking about sucking off beer bottles, but were other things getting sucked off? Well, let's listen to what the brother has to say.
Okay, now that she's gone, I wanted to tell you guys that as her brother, I know that everybody's always questioning whether the allegations are true, even though it's pretty clear to most people who aren't idiots what the reality of the situation is. But my father has sexually groomed my sister, and they have sex all the time. She gives him blowjobs all the time. And they're currently together, even though there's a no contact order in place.
So this is the brother, my understanding this is the brother, confirming that more than beer bottles are getting sucked on, that all the flirtatious, tee-hee, just trolling, just joking, isn't really just trolling, just joking, that daddy and daughter are fucking like rabbits, and sucking and fucking nonstop. Nonstop sucking and fucking going on, according to the brother here. Let's listen further.
So if anybody knows where they are or any information like that, please let somebody, or just call the police, because they're not supposed to be together for reasons.
Could you imagine if he's the one making that 911 call? How uncomfortable would that be? Hello, 911? Oh my God, I need your help. My sister won't stop sucking my father's cock. Can you send SWAT immediately? Can you please? Oh, they're in the woods right now, and she is taking load after load, and I can't stop her. Oh, my God. I tried hitting her with a bat, and she won't take her mouth off his dick. I need emergency services.
That makes sense. Like, one of them is that he kicked her on stream, and he's molested her many different ways. He's physically abusive person. He's terrible. I find him just a repulsive man. I'm ashamed that he's my father. And it's a burden to be his son. Living life after Ben Thorpe is difficult. Living life as a, just, you know, having him as your father is a really difficult struggle. So.
Oh, that's so fucking brutal. Jesus. I feel bad for this kid. I don't know. Again, I don't know much about who he is or really the depth of the family dynamics. And I know I'm joking a lot about this, and it's going to get darker as we go through. But holy shit. Imagine how fucked up that is. Like, you're sitting in your car recording this, and you're aware of everything that's going on, even though you might not have contact with the rest of your family, because they live stream all of it. There's no way to escape it. Like, fucking random strangers know who you are because of this shit. And they're like, dude, is your dad, your sister, are they fucking each other? Because, like, I saw him get arrested 3 times. Like, the pussy must be crazy. This guy's out in the wood in a camper van, and he just won't fucking stop. And, like, what's life like for that poor guy? Welcome to Father's Day. Happy Father's Day. Jesus fucking Christ. Look at the despair on his face.
I hope that Grace can get out of it, but I've already gotten out of it, but it's still just an endless struggle trying to, you know, recuperate myself. Yeah, pretty much. That's
Yeah, pretty much. My sister and dad are fucking, and I want to slit my throat. It's pretty dark, bros. It's pretty fucking dark over here. I don't know what to tell you guys. Holy shit. Now, I wanted to show you a little family dynamic, and I think we should kind of analyze this as we go through, because I think you'll pick up on what I picked up on when I started looking at these clips. Clearly from that first one, you know, after she gets mule kicked and she's like scratching her face and apologizing, you can figure there's some damage. There's some fucked up shit going on here. And then you hear the blowjob story where he's like, oh, she's sucking a beer bottle. And the brother's talking about they suck and fuck all the time. But then you look at the family dynamics. Now, where is the brother? What happened to the brother? Well, the brother got basically thrown into the wind. They tried to get him arrested. He's all crippled and shit. He had a broken leg. He's all busted up. I don't know why. Maybe he tried to stop the blowjobs in process. I don't know. But we're going to look over the footage, and you can kind of see, why would daddy be playing favorites? Why would daddy choose daughter over her son? Well, I think you could figure that out already. And then we're going to see mom, too. And it's just wild how fucked up this is. But it's a little collage, the Thorpe family dynamic.
Yes, I will.
Now, this is a brother and sister arguing. This is him in his apartment, off broken up from some injury or some shit. She comes up, and again, live streaming everything, starts shit with him.
Hey, Gracie.
You're really
bad. What are you doing?
You're really
I'll bad. Enjoy
Get
it.
Out of my apartment. Get out of my fucking apartment, bitch.
Oh,
get out of my apartment.
Now I have physical assault.
You're not allowed
I have
in
physical
here.
Assault on video.
Here whenever you want to.
I have physical
get out
assault
of my
on video. I have physical assault on
oh
video.
Oh my god. Okay, cool.
I have physical assault on video.
Do you think this is winning?
This is not your apartment. I'm allowed up here. I'm on the lease.
Out of here, Grace.
I am
out.
On the lease.
You're not allowed to be up here.
I am
right
on
now.
The lease. You physically assaulted
okay,
me and
Grace.
I'm on the lease.
Okay, get out of here.
Oh, now you choked me. You just choked me. Did he just choke
get out.
Me?
W, you're winning. You're winning.
Do you notice? Okay, the first thing, chat. Do you notice the difference? Now, here he is, the brother, hobbling along, a fucking busted up leg, all injured from whatever the fuck's going on. And he's pushing her out. Get the fuck out of here. And she wants to call the police. She's, you know, fuck you, blah, blah, blah. Daddy mule kicks her. She breaks down into tears, and it's her fault. Brother pushes her together, you know, the fuck out of the apartment. She wants him arrested. I don't know. There's some weird fucking dynamics going on in these male relationships in this family. I'm thinking maybe she's closer to daddy than she is brother.
Get out.
You
you're winning. W.
Me.
Look at him. Look at who cool guy. W. You're
you
winning.
Choked me. I'm
get
on the
out.
Lease. You're so
get
so
out.
You are physically assaulting me when I'm on the lease to be up here
you're
in
winning.
This apartment.
You're winning.
Is that what you just
you
did?
You won. You're winning.
I'm going to turn this into the police.
Okay.
And that's what we're going to do. You
okay.
physically assault
physically
me one
assault.
More time, and I will call the police.
Physically assault.
Yes.
Fuck you. Get out. Fuck off, bitch. Oh, fucking slob. And you go make food and then not clean it up again.
You are going to be evicted for that. And I'm going to press charges against you.
You are?
Yes.
You are?
What are you going to do?
You fucking asshole. Fuck you! You deserve that so much! Fucking slob!
Now that's
hope
on video
too. Fucking hell, Grace.
He threw a shoe at my kittens.
So, okay. So that first part, right, that's like the initial contact. I think this is at the family home and he's like in, above the garage or... I don't know. Again, you'd have to watch the very long form videos of this. I'm giving you the rough and dirty cut as we go through this. But you could tell, brother's the odd man out, obviously. He's not the one sucking beer bottles in between daddy's lap. And so Grace goes and fucks with him. And she's going to get him evicted. And here he is with his dad, Ben, who's 19 feet tall, kicking his cat or something. I don't know. But talking about his fears and trying to get the fuck out of there. And you'll see how this escalates into just insanity.
Yeah, I was unaware the kittens were there.
I told the police officers, I said, honestly, the number one thing I'm like freaking out about right now is what's going on with the cats. Because he said he would strangle them.
Yeah.
I do think he would drown them. Walked out of the room, like hobbled out of it. And then I went down the stairs. I didn't even put shoes on. I grabbed my car keys. I went to my car. I had noise canceling headphones on that I put on. My sister standing behind my.
I see some people in chat saying, "Did he really threaten to kill the cat? Was he really going to kill the cat?" I have it on good authority after investigating this that actually he called in a cat hitman by the name of Mersh, who was going to catnap them and then run a bunch of GoFundMes for them. That's what happened to all the Thorpe cats. Ben gave them to Mersh, and then Mersh ran GoFundMes on them.
My car not letting me back out. My dad screaming at me from the right window, and my mom screaming at me from the left. And then they left, and I thought that it was the coast was clear for a little while, at least. So,
so here he's like narrating over this, right? So here's the fucked up part. And again, I tried to find this part. I couldn't get it really, but it is out there. So he has this confrontation with his sister. Dad comes in, talks shit to him. Whole family's talking shit to him. We're going to get you arrested. We're going to get you evicted. So he's trying to like get out. This is him attempting to flee and take his kitties with him. And they won't let him. Watch the shit they do. Like, it's crazy.
I took out the engine oil because my car has an oil leak still. And it just, I haven't been driving in or keeping up with the oil. So it's just leaked all out. So I had to fill it up before I drove. And then he also grabbed the engine cap, the engine oil cap. And I actually ended up screwing it on and retrieving the engine oil that he stole. Then I slammed it and tried to get back in my car, but he was standing in front of my door blocking it. I was incredibly frightened that they were going to have the cops called on me because I touched him, which I did, up to this point I didn't, and I didn't touch him. And I was incredibly fearful of that happening because it just happened to me the day before. And they were taking videos the whole time and laughing.
Like, imagine how fucked up this dynamic is. And just watching this from the outside, how screwed up this is. So you got your son is crippled for what? I don't know why. Maybe it was an accident. Who fucking knows? He's hobbling around on crutches, concerned about his cats. And he knows that his sister and father are fucking. His sister's screwing with him, trying to get him arrested and evicted. And his dad's getting physical with him. And so all he's trying to do is, like, escape. And they won't even let him get in his car. So they're going to try to make him walk in the rain. Hobble in the rain on his crutches, down the street in his socks. Your crippled son. Your crippled son you're going to force to walk down the street. Like, what the fuck, dude?
And then I walked away and tried to walk to the police station. But I realized that wasn't going to really happen because I was wearing socks. And it was like, it's like rainy here. So, like, there's puddles everywhere, and it was fucking crazy. Then I went back to my car. And at that point, I think he moved, so I was able to get in the driver's seat, but...
He's got that powered-up Timmy Trot. Timmy! You see him just hobbling his way over there. If I can get in the car, I can get the fuck out of here. Oh.
He blocked the door from shutting. So what happened from there was...
And so this is a part that got cut out. It's like barely visible on the initial footage. I'm sure somebody has it. I wish they just put the unredacted fucking clip up. But Ben kicks the door on his broken leg. Like, this kid's fucked up leg is halfway out the door, and he starts kicking it. He starts kicking his crippled son. And then it picks up here where Grace decides to get in the act. You know, the daughter gets in the act. By like, well, just watch.
And then she got off after like 20 seconds of sitting on the hood of my car to stand in front of it and threaten me to like knock her over. And then I sped off and I was like questioning whether to go to the police station first. But then I was like, I'm fucked. Yeah. Like I'm fucked in every way. There's no other, like, I don't want to waste policemen's time, but like,
so, that's a brother story. Okay. Crippled, thrown out of the house, assaulted, intimidated, fleeing for his safety. Who fucking knows? What I do know is, and there's more footage out there and you can find it in these long form videos if they're interest to you. But what I do know is it was like a race to the police station to see who could get footage to the cops first. But they tried to like nail him, and then footage showed up because, again, remember how Grace is always like, this is the funny part to me, the daughter is always like, I'm so sorry, daddy, but every time shit goes down, like, she's the one that's put the evidence out there. It's very strange. It's like some subconscious thing. Like, if he really has been molesting her and he's been taking advantage of his daughter, like, she's got some part of her primal brain that hates that. And so, subconsciously, she fucks him over as much as she can. So she films him when he breaks the no contact order. She films him when he assaults her. And she filmed when he assaulted her brother. And she's the one that releases it. She was the one that was showing the footage. And then she had to delete it because she fucked up and gave him evidence that he could bring to the police. Now, here's Mom. Oh, you know. Three sheets to the wind. Streaming from downstairs, and let's look at the dynamic between mom and daughter.
It's rolling. My ex Hollywood Ben Thorpe. It's just like, it's coming. Ow, fucking bitch. Get up. My scream. Okay. That was enough of that. Am I right?
Daddy's mine now, bitch. Say goodbye. Daddy's all mine. Get out, mommy. I've driven brother out, and I'm driving mommy out, and now daddy belongs to me. Sorry, daddy. Got you arrested for the 15th fucking time. Oopsie doodles. Wow. Welcome to the Thorpe family, ladies and gentlemen. That's not even... There's so many clips. There's so many clips of crazy shit they've said and done. And it just goes on and on. But I, you know, I picked one last clip I wanted to finish out the Thorpe segment with for contestant number one. For contestant number one. Oh, really? It's the only contestant. Come on, let's be honest here. It's just another, you know, I'm going to let it play. I'm not even going to comment. I'm going to let chat give me your opinion on this. Let's see what you think.
And his mother sort of agreed with him. It was crazy. Totally crazy. Nothing to do with YouTube.
Oh, yeah.
He found some... Whatever, you know, this is when his mother was, I mean, this isn't really like YouTube, right? So he went through, he was convinced of this somehow. I think his mother was telling him. So he went through his sister's phone and she sent me something, you know, a teenage girl will send something. Maybe it was an emoji of a...
I think eggplant. Phrase it was, really hey, can you come up here and bring that big dick with you? And
yeah, right.
Plant emojis?
Yeah.
I have no... memory, I don't know.
Saying, I think I'm the most sexually normal guy in the world. I was told.
Now, let's see. Oh, you know what, chat? Let's take a poll. I'm not even going to put a poll up because I'll get banned off YouTube for putting this into words. Let's take a poll, chat. He thinks he's the most sexually normal person in the world. What is his follow-up statement going to be, chat? What do you think that statement's going to be followed with? When somebody, after what you've seen, what do you think the most sexually normal person in the world is going to say is sexually normal? What do you think is going to the follow-up of this going to be? Just, I'm going to give you a minute to really ponder it, to really just consult your crystal balls. Really give it a thinkaroo. Oh, I see some people. You're hitting on it so hard you don't even know. Here we go. Here we go. You've had a moment to think on it. Let's check it out.
I have someone who goes to my chat who's a 16-year-old girl, and I was told, like, it's really, really a problem. I was like, what would be the problem? I chat with her. I would meet her in person. I would tell a 6-year-old girl that her dress looked pretty.
Ben.
I'm a pedophile in the Greek sense, Mike.
Oh, okay. Let's just back that up for a second. Just in case it slipped in the Greek sense. Have you even read Locke? Listen, intellectually speaking, I don't care what age they are. He just dropped a digit. Okay, that was pretty quick. Like in the span of 4 seconds, we dropped an entire digit. All right, a placement. We've moved from 16 to 6.
Girl, that her dress looked pretty.
Ben.
I'm a pedophile in the Greek sense, Mike. Lover of children. I love children, especially girls.
Oh, Ben.
I love children, especially little girls.
I think you should be less ambiguous about that.
And I like to, I guess you could call it flirting, flirt with little girls and say like, nope. How pretty they look.
I don't like that.
Oh, I think that's your problem, guys. A normal man loves to flirt with a little girl and say, are you a pretty little girl?
Oh, you know, a normal man. Hey, guys, it's totally normal. Can we go back to that original arrest footage, or the assault, I'm sorry, and just now that you've listened to this, let's take a look at her reaction. and just see if that's any deep-seated fucking trauma popping its head up.
That's literally not why.
Father of the year, folks. Father of the year. Happy Father's Day. So, Ben Thorpe, arrested 3 times, breaks no contact order, has his own son come out and say that he's been fucking his daughter and having her suck his dick, admitted on stream to having her perform, mock fellatio on beer bottles in his lap. We see that they drove the son out of the house, the mom driven out of the house, the daughter's getting in catfights with her. They're off in an RV in the fucking woods somewhere doing God knows what. Constantly flirting, constantly all this, putting out statements about how, not just 16-year-old little girls, but 6-year-olds, you know, the Greek sense of the word. That's a new one on me. I've never really heard anybody pull that out as like an argument. No, you don't understand. It's in the Greek sense of it. Oh, okay. What, you speak a different language when you molest them? What does that mean in the Greek sense of it? You offer the child a gyro when you commit sodomy? What do you mean in the Greek sense of it? I guess it's not computing for me. I'm having some difficulty understanding exactly what in the Greek sense of it means. I guess I'm not highly educated enough to pull this one off, to figure it out. So, you know, we looked at the Ralph dad, right? You know, and Ralph's got his own issues, but boy, oh boy, Ben takes the cake. And like, you need to understand that what I've shown you is fractional. It's minute. It's itty bitty, tiny, teeny weeny compared to the trove, just the depth and breadth of shit that's out there, of interviews and live streams and shit that's been said just blatantly and openly. Now, I've heard some people say that, he had a normal life and was successful and had a decent job and decided he wanted to become like a YouTuber and everything went to shit. Like, I don't know what the story is. And I know one of those 3-hour documentaries would probably explain it. So if you want to see the dark side of father-daughter relationships that is just out in the open on YouTube, everybody fucking seems to know about it. It's really weird. It's just out there. Just out there. Now the cops are involved. Who knows where this goes? There you go. It's the Thorpe family. It's the Thorpe family. Now, we've been going for a little over an hour here, so we'll take our first little break. When we come back, we're gonna take a look at a more classic example of a daddy on the internet. Luckily, one that, isn't fucking his daughter, but beats her nonetheless. Gotta have some of that abuse in there to make it a story that's relatable. So let me put on a merchandise video because I'm a whore. And we'll take a 5-minute break, grab a drink. We'll come back and we're going to continue on with contestant number 2 for Father of the Year. Or just the second person we're going to look at. It's a tale as old as time. It's an older one. The Thorpes are the new shit. Okay, this is like the recent past couple of years. A person we're going to be looking at, this is like 13, 14, 15 years ago. But it's a classic. It's an oldie. It's a goodie, though. So, take 5-minute break. Everybody grab a drink. We're coming back. We're going full bore. By buying a goddamn American capitalist hat. Oh, got to use that USA dollars to do it. Where are you going to do that, you ask? Well, you don't really ask, but I'm going to show you anyway. Fuck you. I'm going to show you anyway. Oh, look at those hats. Quality fucking hats, ladies and gentlemen. Wear it around town, it looks fancy. Buy a hat for your hat. Buy a hat for your hat. Buy a hat for your hat. We'll be right back. look at those hats. Quality fucking hats, ladies and gentlemen. Buy a hat for your hat. Buy a hat for your hat. Wear it around town. It looks fancy. Buy a hat for your hat. When I'm sad, pay me. It's the only cure, really. When you're very sad, you need to pay me money. You gotta buy my fucking hats. All right, that's the only way you're gonna teach these communists their fucking place. These lemon-loving motherfuckers. It's by buying a goddamn American capitalist hat. Oh, gotta use that USA dollars to do it. Buy a hat for your hat. Quality fucking hats, ladies and gentlemen. Buy a hat for your hat. Wear it around town and it's fancy. Buy a hat for your hat. Love the red, white, blue. Love my apple pie and baseball. Sometimes I just look at the Statue of Liberty. It's so goddamn beautiful. Oh, that is good stuff. You know what? Buy a hat for your hat. Buy a hat for your hat. You know what? Buy a hat for your hat. To sell you beautiful fucking hats. We all love Jim's hats. Let me move a little bit. Over on Shopify. Metokur.myshopify.com. Buy the finest hats available. You gotta do this. You're gonna do that over at my store. Buy my hats. Teach the communists a lesson. Fuck the lemon. Buy a hat. You gotta do this. Buy my hats. I gotta do this. Buy my hat. You know what? Buy a hat for your hat. I gotta do this. Buy my hat. I gotta do this. Buy a hat for your hat. Quality. Buy my hat. I gotta do this. Buy a hat for your hat. I gotta do this. Buy my hat. I gotta do this. Buy a hat for your hat. Oh, holy shit. Okay. Oh, we're back. We're back, Chant. Hopefully you had a chance to wash that taste out of your mouth as we looked at Internet Daddy number one. I'm getting when I went to go get a drink, when I went to, you know, just go do my thing for a second here, my wife was like, oh, she's angry with you about the load thing, about the jokes you were making. Apparently some of the Thorpes are watching the stream, a little bit upset. Listen, I'm not the one that shot nut down your throat, okay? That wasn't me. I didn't mule kick you, all right? It was not my dick playing tonsil hockey in your mouth, okay? Sorry. wasn't me. Wasn't Jimmy. Jimmy's a good boy. Jimmy didn't do it. All right. You might want to direct the anger at the ogre. Not at me. Sorry about that. Sorry about that. Sorry if you got a little upset about that. Jim, how can you say such cruel and mean things? Easily. 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 Super easily. Okay. Well, now we're done. I'm done with the Thorpes. So if the Thorpes are still sniping, you know, watching, whatever. We've moved past your segment. You can stick around and watch what's coming up. I mean, that's fine. But I don't know if it's going to interest you. It doesn't involve sucking beer bottles and shit out of people's crotches. But we'll see. Now, moving on, it's a little bit of a throwback. A little bit of an oldie but a goodie. A little slaughter action. And I'm talking about Sergeant Slaughter here. No G.I. Joes. I'm talking about a very mad dad. He's going to backtrace some shit on the internet.
Okay, this is Jimmy Slaughter. I just wanted to tell you guys that you ruined my life. My household has been torn ever since you guys started doing this. I haven't been able to do anything.
Okay. And don't be saying suicide.
I'm not. I'm saying I haven't been able to eat. I haven't been able to sleep.
Well, guess what? And my daughter's not lying. And I'm not going to put up with any of you people's crap anymore. If you ain't got something nice to say about my daughter, then keep your mouth shut, and any more of your comments to put on there, I'm recording them all, and they are being sent to the police department.
They have been being
and guess what? Your emails will be caught and will be found. And who said you're going to beat my daughter up? You will have to deal with the police because you done goofed.
You done goofed. So we've got a little girl here, you know. Yeah, it starts a little bit of shit over on Tumblr, if I remember right. God, it's been forever with the Jesse Slaughter shit. But she started some shit, ran her mouth quite a bit, got into a bunch of fights. A lot of people talked a lot of shit to her. And her dad decides to step in, telling everybody, you done goofed. You fucked up. You're fucking with the wrong hombre.
See, I haven't been able to eat or sleep or anything. I was just shopping. I've been having emotional breakdowns in a row. No, just been hating on me. And whoever's making fun of me on Tumblr and shit. He's like such assholes. Okay, you're good.
And I apologize for the shit audio quality, but again, these videos are like 14 fucking years old. Like, and I'm terrible with audio and video processing anyway, so you just have to bear with it, but you'll get the gist of it.
You don't want to say that you guys have ruined my life.
I'm going to tell you right now, this is from her father. You bunch of lying, no good punks. And I know who it's coming from because I back-traced it. And I know who's emailing and who's doing it. And you've been reported to the cyber police and the state police. Ray, you better write one more thing or screw with my computer again. You'll be arrested. End of conversation from her father.
I have to admit, okay, it's charming, right? When you first encounter this story, you've got this little girl that runs her mouth and gets into a bunch of shit online, and here comes dad. He's completely computer illiterate. Consequences will never be the same. He's going to backtrace it, cyber police. You've got all these great fucking quotes, but really you're like, oh, that's kind of sweet, right? It's an old man. He's stepping in there. You know, he's defending his daughter. It's embarrassing. I'm sure she's mortified. You know, he looks foolish, but you know, it's a dad. He loves his kid. You know, he's gonna teach those pricks online a lesson. He's you're not gonna fuck with my kid. Fuck you. I'm gonna backtrace you. He doesn't know what to say. He doesn't know how to fight it. He's completely, completely inept when it comes to dealing with the internet, but he's still putting his foot forward to really do the right thing. What a great dad. Because nobody hurts his daughter except for him. Jesse Slaughter, dad charged with child abuse. The father of a Florida 7th grader who profanity-laced video prompted online death threats last year has been arrested for allegedly assaulting his daughter. Gene Leonhardt, 53, was charged by police in Multnomah County, Florida with child abuse in the incidents which occurred last month. According to the police report, first reported on the Smoking Gun website, the girl said she had been arguing with her father when he punched her, causing her to have a bloody and swollen lip. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, Daddy. Don't you dare touch my daughter, my little pumpkin. I love my little girl. Anybody that threatens her, I'm going to kick their ass. By the way, I'm going to go beat my little girl. I'm going to hit her real hard. I'm going to smack the shit out of her. Nobody touches my daughter but me. Honey, get the belt. I backtrace those trolls. It's time to beat our daughter. Now, funny enough, there's actually, I believe this is audio of the beating itself. Let's listen in to dad and daughter having a heart-to-heart conversation.
Investigate! I might go to jail tomorrow!
I know that. The mom just bitch. It's like I wasn't even on a webcam. Thank you. Goodbye.
Shut up.
He's screaming so loud he's peeking the microphone in the background. She's sitting at like a laptop. He is screaming so loud he has fucked the audio. Like that's a primal scream. Like he must have He-Man punched her through the wall.
Life's
gonna be better.
Can you ever shut
the fuck
up?
Why is your mouth
after us?
Don't
unplug that computer.
You're such a fucking mouth. Don't tell me come back tomorrow and I might give a.
Now, did you hear that? Let's back it up. Let's back that up.
Don't unplug that computer.
You're such a fucking.
That right there. Don't touch that computer. Smack. Let's hear it one more time.
Don't unplug that computer!
You're such a fucking mouth! Don't tell me come back tomorrow and I might give a fuck! Jessica, I don't trust anybody! Anybody! Especially your friends! And you can tell them all that on the internet! They're a bunch of untrustworthy little bitch brats!
I mean, Dad kinda was right, because this audio got recorded and put up by her bitch brat friends. I don't trust anybody, not even myself.
And they lie about their ages, people, off the internet. Every one of them is fired.
It's 12.
Lie!
I've talked to my mom. Do you want to talk to my mom? Do you want to talk to Chelsea's mom?
Arguing with me.
I'm just saying, you think
I... Why was your webcam on?
Because I was trying to adjust the settings to get it off. I'm trying to get it so that it'll only show
up. Do you realize how serious this is?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, how do you? Why, you're still on the internet. If you realize you'd be off of it right now.
Yeah, okay.
What do you mean, yeah, okay, Jessica? The internet's what's got us where we are. Shut up, Diane.
It's just... He's fucking screaming at everybody. He's screaming at his daughter because now he feels like an ass because I'm sure every troll in A-Log back in the day was fucking with him. And then he's screaming at his wife who's yelling at him for yelling at his daughter.
Why do you want to lose your daughter? Why do you want to lose her? Why do you want to lose your daughter? That shuts your mouth.
It is off, mother.
Jessica, they're all a bunch of bullshit.
Chelsea isn't.
You
can talk to her mom.
Oh, God, I love recording this shit.
Really? You want me to call Chelsea right now?
No, Jessica, the cops are watching the internet right now.
They're watching me sit here with a picture, and that's it.
Jessica, they are watching every word you're saying, and you keep typing. Stop typing.
I just typed dot, 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 and then I typed a frowny face.
Tell everyone you can't talk anymore. You are being thoroughly investigated.
Okay.
Well, you need to see, you realize just how serious this situation is.
She done goofed. Oh my God. Could it get any worse? So she causes a shitstorm by running her mouth and gets everybody to make fun of her. Dad steps in and is then driven into a violent rage by her constantly going on the internet. And he assaults her and he gets arrested. How much worse could it get? Oh, I know. How about he dies? How about he's dead? How about she literally drove him to death? What kind of... This is his fucking obituary from Boing Boing. Gene Leonhard, you done goofed dad, dead at 53. Uh-oh. Oopsie. Oh, no. Uh-oh. Am I having a little connectivity issue here? Hold on, chat. One second. Things froze up on me. I've got to restart something. Hopefully this keeps going. And everything didn't just go to shit on me. But it might have. I'm just going to keep talking and pretending like it's working. And then hope that everything hasn't gone to shit on me. Because it would really suck if it did. Uh-oh. Oh, you got to be kidding me. I think I got disconnected. Oh, nope, there we go. I see people typing F in chat, but I think we're still good. I think we're still good. All good. Okay. All good. Somebody said no sound. Let me just double check that. Got technical issues. Got storms over here. Everything's going to shit. Oh, let's see if it's working. If you're just fucking with me. Oh, no, we're good. Okay, we're good. All right. I'll just continue where I left off, which was talking about how this girl drove this man to death. And his fucking obituary is a Boing Boing article. Gene Leonhard, you done goofed dad, dead at 53. And that's good. You know, I tried to look at like a source for this. I was like, is this just bullshit? And there's like a screen cap of like a Facebook post talking about how he's dead. And then like a Boing Boing article in a live journal with a dead cash to a mortuary site. And that's it. That's all there is. That's literally all there is. That moves so fast. Life comes at you quick, I guess. One minute your daughter's acting like a retard on the internet, and then the next thing you're driven into a violent rage, and then you have a heart attack because the violent rage has literally pushed you to your limit. All within the span of, like, months. I know people are familiar with Jesse Slaughter. I know a lot of you have probably seen clips of the I'm gonna back crazy, you done goof, the consequences will never be the same. You probably maybe didn't know that he's dead. He literally keeled over. His daughter literally made him keel over. Now, she went on to do some weird shit. She was, like, trying to date some dude from some shitty emo goth band when she was, like, a young teen. And he's, like, in his 20s. And then I think she transitioned and he's a he now. I don't know. Like, the whole Jesse Slaughter story is fucking weird to the very end. But the dad part of it, you know, the father part of it, starts off as, like, this kind of folksy hero kind of guy of you can't fuck with my daughter. And then next thing you know, he's beating her. There's shit getting dropped to him just beating the shit out of her. Oh, Father's Day. Everybody loves it. You know, now might be a good time to take a very small break and read a few of the Ko-Fi things that have come through and a few of the Cash App things that have come through before we move on to the next segment. Which I like to call, by the way, I named the next segment Fatherless. We've seen what it's like when you've got Dad of the Year. Let's see what it's like when Dad of the Year ain't there. I think you're going to enjoy it. I literally, one of these is titled Poop Trouble. can't leave. I mean, it's Father's Day, but you can't forget about the single moms, folks. And what better way to celebrate than with a video called Poop Trouble? From Kex and Hex. Jim, I know you're sorry that our dads were just dudes that pawed our moms in the back of a Prius. Anything exciting on the health front? Don't. Still fucking awful. Still fucking awful. From Phantom. Jim, you doing this report on the family, does it make you feel, does it make you the godfather? Are you talking about the Thorpes? No, I don't want to be the godfather of that family. Kevin says, Kevin Nash in Summer of 92 says, I may have missed it, but what do you think about people saying that Rikeda's 16-year-old son should have stepped up so that his parents continue their lifestyle? I think that sounds pretty fucking stupid to dump all your responsibilities on a teenager. I mean, teenagers are, of course, completely capable of taking care of themselves. You know, you're 16 years old. You can probably do the majority of shit you need to do. But trying to put all the responsibilities of a household on a 16-year-old? That sounds pretty fucking sketchy to me. Should the son sacrifice his childhood so, what, mom and dad can sort some coke? No, I wouldn't agree with that at all. That boy's the one that should have been feeding them SpaghettiOs, not Aaron. It's just a dumb argument. From Jinx, trolling Jesse Slaughter back in the day was great. Spamming low orbit ion cannon on her IP, sending pizza to her address, spamming tags on her Tumblr. It was great. Yeah, it's very old internet. It's like 15 years old. I mean, it's been forever. That was fucking forever ago. From Tav Nazan, which I butchered your name. I know I did. Jimbo, you have to close the stream with the Back Traced It song. I will look it up. I'll see if I can find it. Zero Sketch, check out the demo for Proprieta? 90s graphics. Not sure if that's a game or if that's like a desktop. Is that a browser? What is that? E is for elbow. E is for elbow smash. Already bought a hat for my hat's hat, so take this tip instead. Happy Father's Day. Well, thank you very much. Oh, big money from Phantasm. Glad you're alive, Dad. Happy Father's Day. I'm almost glad that you take too long to get milk and not make us suck on the canoa bottle. What a weird thing to admit. Who does that? Why would you go on stream and tell people that you make your daughter suck a beer bottle in your lap? How are people supposed to take that? Especially with your son running around telling everybody that she's sucking your cock. And then you go talk about the Greek way. Just foolishness. Hiding in a van in the fucking forest. What the fuck? From Gav, hey Jim, thanks for the stream, buddy. While this Slurp stuff is dark, oh it is. There's a lot more dark shit out there too, believe me. All right, I read a few of the co-files. I'll get to everybody's too at the end of the stream, but try to bounce between the two. I've got some Cash App ones here. Let me read some of these. And then we'll get back to the fatherless portion. Guess why wouldn't we? From Sig, we need some Gary Plotch energy. That's what he's saying out there. From Matt, we need some... Why? Oh, no, that was very strange. From Matt. Love you, Jimbo. God bless. Well, God bless you as well. We got a 1488 here from Owen. Thanks, Jim. Well, you're very welcome. You're very welcome from Ryan Wolf. For a stalker child, enjoy freedom. I will. I've got my pepperoni sitting right next to me. It's delicious. I'm enjoying it quite a bit. From Jalen. Could we get an NNRU, Daddy Jimbo? Oh, well, if we were on Odyssey, we could. Over here, I don't know. I mean, I know Susan's out of the picture, but God knows what they're doing over here. From Danny. Jimco, happy Father's Day to Topher. Love you, Jim. Oh, thank you very much. I'll read one more here. And then we'll jump back in. From Mark, here's a tenor, Jimbo. God bless you and Jade. Well, thank you very much. Now, chat. We've got a few things to go through in our fatherless portion of this. Again, I know. It's fun. It's fun to look at the goofy shit, you know, the goofy dads. You know, we got, you know, Gene there, who's dead, driven to death by rage, and Ben, who is, it's amazing how many times he gets out of jail, really, I've got to give him some credit for it, he's a very slippery motherfucker, arrested 3 times, out the next day each time, it's kind of stunning. Oh, yeah, we got that, we looked at the Ralph dad a little bit, obviously it speaks for itself, but now, let's look at the dad's not here, or dad's not active portion of the stream. I selected a few. These are clips you're probably familiar with, but they're fun and they're classic, and we're going to look at them. And I'll let you know, I'm going to save... Which one do we want to start with? You know, I'm going to start with Nathan. We've done this one before over on Odyssey, I believe, but maybe some of you aren't familiar with it. And I just want to show you what the effect of... You know what? This kid gets recorded in one of the most embarrassing moments you can imagine. And I am fucking dead certain that he hates his mother because of it. Like, it's just permanent. Like, there's no unfucking this. Like, this kid, this, like, a switch got flipped. You know what I mean? Like, he can't go back to liking or loving her ever again because of the embarrassment of this, what you're about to hear. And from that point onward, it becomes a vicious back and forth between a single mother and her son. And because dad is out of the picture. I believe dad divorced mom and got the fuck out of there. So let's jump into this household of the Roblox kid.
You listen.
It's a virus.
Listen, Harris, and I'm sorry, but I need you. I have to have your dad talk to you about this because mom's not very good about
it. No, mom.
I
was searching around. I was searching around the. I was searching around.
Why are you playing with yourself?
What a horrible question to ask your son, by the way. If there are any mothers watching this, never ever utter that phrase to a boy. Why were you, why, Nathan, why were you touching your tallywacky, Nathan, why were you touching your little tallywacky, Nathan, why were you looking mommy in the eyes and telling why you were playing with your penis, Nathan?
I was searching around the internet.
Oh my gosh. Okay, listen.
No, you're curious. I was searching around the I was searching around the internet, and all of a sudden, I was downloading this thing, and I got a computer virus.
I want to see it. Show me what you were downloading.
You show me, Nathan. You show mommy what smut you were looking. Look mommy in the eyes, Nathan. Now you show mommy the pornography.
Loading. I randomly, deleted the virus.
No, you did not. I have to have your dad go through all this.
I got scared because I deleted the virus and
No, you're embarrassed.
No, mom,
Nathan,
for real.
You listen to me. You don't.
Holy shit. Yeah, no shit. He's embarrassed. He's in the middle of a multiplayer match. He's in the middle of a multiplayer match. You caught him with his pants down and you won't stop. Yes, he's embarrassed. Why are you so horrible? What did he do to you to deserve this? Talk about childhood trauma. Oh, God.
I didn't.
All right, I have to go to the bathroom.
My parents. Oh, my God. You don't get it, do you, Mom? Mom, you don't get it at all. I didn't.
Oh, it's that special age, isn't it? That special age for this woman, where her kid is technically becoming a teenager, but she thinks of him as a little boy, so she can't call it a dick or a penis. So she just sings songs it out and says, playing with your ding dong, playing with your little tallywacky ding dong, who's it, Hazel? Oh, you're flogging the wazzles. It's just this sing song baby talk shit as this kid's just got caught jacking off.
Oh my God, Mom! I had a computer virus, and I got scared that I had the virus. And when I was getting out of my chair, my pants were slipping, and I was pulling them up and getting back on the chair. Mom, it was a virus!
God, Mom, you're so technically illiterate. All right? Obviously, you don't understand how operating systems function. Fuck! Viruses constantly scare pants off people. That's why they're terrifying. Nobody wants to be nude, Mom! Don't you understand? Bitch, you're still using Vast as a browser. You're like 90 years old. Get with the times, you old bitch!
It was a virus, Mom! I got scared, and my pants slipped down a little, and I was pulling them off! Mom, I'm telling the truth! Yes, and then I was pulling them up because I got scared of the virus! Oh my God, Mom, for real! Mom! I'm serious!
Now, she could just let this go, right? Okay, let's be real here, if you're a parent. You've walked in on your child, and you've caught them doing something embarrassing. Now, you've got like two choices, let's be honest here. You've got three choices. You could choose the wrong option, which is what she's doing, by continuing this conversation and clearly mortifying the fuck out of him. The other option, the better option, just let it go. Just let it go. If you want to have him have the birds and the bees talk with dad later on, then have dad do that, but don't constantly dredge it up and humiliate him. The third option I like to call the wild card option is you just start applauding. You walk in on your kid, you've got them masturbating, they're freaking out, pulling their pants up, you just start clapping. You just clap. That's all you do. You don't say a fucking word. You just clap, and you walk out of the room. That's it. Nothing. You never speak of it again. Think of the memory that leaves with them. How do they even comprehend what just happened? That's the funny option. But she goes with the worst one.
No, Mom! I'm serious!
Here we go. So there, the thing with this kid is his friends record him all the time, or he's recording himself all the time. So that was the initial mom fight. It's a snippet of it. But this is where it turns. Okay. This is where the single mom nightmare begins. Because he is pissed and he wants blood. All right. She has fucking humiliated him in the most thorough way you can humiliate a young boy on the verge of puberty. And the emotional psychological damage is just, is mind fucked him. And he wants fucking blood. So it's war. Little Roblox Nathan is going, Awesome Nader, I think his name is. He's going to fucking war, boys. All right. Strap in, boots on. We're talking trench fucking warfare against mommy. Listen to this shit. This kid drops bombs on her.
Talk to me like that because I'm telling Dad. I'm going to talk to Dad about it.
Yeah, is Dad your father?
No, he's your father, and he's not going to be too happy.
Then why do you act like he's yours?
Nathan, smarten up and go to bed. You have to get up.
I already am smart. I'm going to fifth grade.
No, you're not. Because you know what? You don't listen
to mother. Oh, yeah, I am. You're not.
No, you're not smartening up because you don't listen to your mother.
Who are you, Mrs. Government?
Let's go, please.
Fucking boom. Headshot, bitch. What are you, the government? Huh, Mom? I'm going to the fifth grade, bitch. You can't stop me. What, you think you Donald Trump or some shit? Huh? Joe Biden? What you gonna do? What you gonna do, bitch? I'm going to the fifth grade.
Nathan, I said to shut it off. Why don't you listen to me?
Why do you act like Mrs. President?
I said to get off! I'm getting so sick of this every night!
Well, get on my face and I'll shut it off. Gee!
Well, geez, I say it nicely. Nathan, please. How many times have I called you? Every single night.
How's that nice of you?
I'm so sick of this! Come with you!
Uh-oh. I hear signs of physical... Are we noticing a theme, by the way, chat? This Father's Day, every kid's getting hit. Oh, mommy tried the... let's talk it out. Let's talk about your little tallywhacker ding-dong. He tells her, hey, Miss Government, fuck yourself. All of a sudden, here come the slaps.
On my face and I'll shut it off. Gee.
Well, geez, I say it nicely. Nathan, please. How many times have I called you? Every single night.
How's that nice of you?
I want you out.
She's gonna throw her fucking 10-year-old into the street because he said I've had enough of your shit, Mrs. Government.
Now I'm not shutting up. Cause
yeah, you will.
Fine, God.
Is this what you want? Is this how I have to respond to you?
I don't know.
I talk to you and I
close your child support right now. I'm done.
I know he's talking about child protective services, but he's like, call child support. And this Mrs. Government smacked me. Call child support. Bitch, we're going to war.
And hurt you. You hurt me every time you don't listen to me. Do you understand me?
Child support phone number.
Nathan, don't you dare.
I will.
You will never have a mother again.
That's your fault.
Oh, roasted. Oh, this bitch got cooked. Ugh. Call Gordon Ramsay up. That's some well-done shit. Oh, you're never going to have a mommy again. That's your fault, bitch. Oh, Miss Government, you're not so cocky now, are you? Get child support on the line. I'm serving your ass. Well done.
You don't do that to me.
Hit your son with a complete douchebag. Watch what happens.
You know what, Nathan? Start listening. Okay? That's being a douchebag.
That's the only solution, hitting?
No, it's not.
Don't do it!
But you know what?
You're fucking violent, Mom. What's your fucking problem? No wonder Dad left you. Hitting people? Huh? Huh? You're more violent with me than I was with my ding-dong, bitch!
And maybe Mom won't have to respond like that.
Well, you know what? You're,
now I see
you're a bad mother. You're a bad mother.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are.
Well, you're a bad son because you don't listen.
Go ahead. Tell me what you want to say. It's not going to offend me because you're...
It's not going to affect me either because I'm sick of this.
Listen to me!
Get out of my face!
Go to bed. Now I know why your father actually...
Well, you know what? If you're gonna be a complete douche like that, then I won't shut it down.
Talk to me like that. I gave you life. And you treat me like crap.
The only thing you're trying to specifically give me right now is a bunch of bruises because you don't know how to parent properly.
No,
oh, he's fucking roasted her ass. I gave you life. No, you gave me a concussion. You gave me a concussion. I'm living with Dad now.
It's not true.
It is true.
Nathan, I asked you. Please go to bed. You have to get up in the morning.
Yes, hitting me in the head a million times asking. Okay. Get the heck out of my room.
You know what, Nathan? I didn't hit you when I asked you. I said it, Nathan. I called to you since 10:30. Actually, 20 after.
Yeah, and you said I can stay on.
No, I said I want you off by 10.
You know, you should really keep your word because you said I can stay on for a little bit longer. And you still keep causing bullcrap.
You know, I bet she's the type of chick that brings her kid into counseling and is like, he's got oppositional defiance disorder or something like that. Like, he doesn't listen to me. You know, but she never explains the backstory of how she humiliated him by catching him masturbating and talking about his ding-dong in front of everybody on the internet and just humiliating him and then smacking him around. You know, she forgets to bring that up. He's the problem. But you could tell he's ready for war. This kid's not fucking around anymore. He's calling child support.
Nathan, I said at 10 o'clock, please get off so you can go to bed and watch a show.
And then he said I can stay up longer. So bull crap.
No, I didn't.
Bull crap.
You know what? Stop talking to me like that. Your friends act better than you.
Cool. I don't care.
Go to bed now. You better listen.
No, because you kept hitting me.
Nathan?
You
can... again?
No.
Because then go to bed.
God, you're annoying.
Is that how I have to respond to you? I don't like
you. I don't like you either. You're a bad mother! You're a bad mother! You're a bad mother! You're a bad mother! Hey, everyone! My mom thinks hitting is the only solution!
What a giga chat. Now imagine this. He's doing this with his window wide open. Imagine he walked over to the window and opened it fully so every neighbor could hear him for like 3 blocks around. And he's got his head tilted out the window and he's doing it. And he's just staring at the doorway waiting for her to run back up in her robe. He's like, yeah, come on. Come on, we're not done yet. Yeah, well, catch me masturbating, will you? Okay, well, let's see what the neighborhood thinks.
Kyle, stop! Come on!
That's enough!
Well, it's true.
Go to bed. You don't holler like that.
You think it's such a big deal about me not going to bed at stupid 10:30? It's such a big deal that you hit your own son? You shouldn't even be hitting your son in the first place. Terrible mother you are.
I don't mean to do that. The next time...
If you don't mean to do it, then don't do it at all.
Then listen to me. Stop making
Well, you know what? Even if I didn't listen. Even if I didn't listen, you shouldn't be the douchebag who hits their own son.
Stop calling me that.
Well, yeah.
You're the douchebag, son, that can't go to bed when he's told. What?
This is victory. That was the moment of victory, folks. If you're a parent and you're arguing with your child and they call you some silly name like a douchebag and your only response is to get so frustrated and asshurt that you're like, nah, you're the douchebag. She lost. That's it. Game, set, match. This young man, Giga Chad Awesomenator, has thoroughly dominated her. She is just a tizzy. She doesn't know what to do anymore. He's calling child support. She's all fucked up.
If you're going to have a problem with being called those names, then you're going to have...
They're not going to start calling you
that. Then
that's
your problem, because you're the person that even brought it up.
Well, they're not going to start calling you that, because you call me that.
And that makes
you... I guess you like that.
And that makes you even more of one.
Well, that makes you more of one, too. It goes both ways.
God, listen to her voice. She's reverted to playground mentality. Do you hear that? I guess that means you're a piece of shit. This kid has fucked this woman up hard in under 5 minutes. I told you, he wanted blood.
Ha ha, you're...
Go to bed.
Ha ha, you're a douchebag.
Nathan?
Yeah, you said you're gonna call me one. Call me one. I'm not gonna be
Go
offended.
To bed. I'm done.
No, I'm not offended. I'm not offended.
Well, I'm not offended by you. Go to bed. I've had it.
Yeah, sure you're not. If you're not offended, then why are you crying like a little baby?
I'm not even crying.
Yeah, what's up, Miss Government? Why you sobbing like a bitch, douchebag? Why you crying, mom? Let me open this window up and tell the neighbors about how abusive you are, douchebag.
You were. You're like, why don't you respect me?
That's not showing me any respect.
Now, you know what? Well, you know what? You don't need respect if you're going to be hitting your son, physically hitting your son, claiming you're going to call them names like that.
I don't do that.
So basically, you don't even deserve the stuff that you want.
Nathan, what is your problem?
What is your problem?
If you're pissed because Dad and I aren't together, you're not going to take it out on me. I don't care anymore. Is that your problem?
No. The problem is that you're a bad parent.
Fucking savage as fuck. Oh, savage. Well, mother, let me tell you what the real problem is. About 2 weeks ago, while I was masturbating in the privacy of my own room, you kicked the door open and called my penis a ding-dong. And then you wouldn't shut the fuck up about it. And now we're going to war, mother.
No, I'm not, Nathan.
The war, did you... Oh, really? What the heck was that crap?
I am tired of you. This is my home.
What was that crap the past 20 minutes ago?
You don't raise your voice to me, ever. You're going to start showing respect to me.
Well, guess who's raising their voice, too.
Go to bed now. I asked you too many times. I'm going to bed way too late. I have to go up in 5 hours. So don't you. Go to bed.
Okay. So first of all, if you actually want me to go to bed, then why do you keep bringing up a bunch of bullcrap?
Go to bed, please.
I can't if you're bringing up bullcrap. You should realize that by now.
I don't see you going.
Yeah, and I don't see you leaving, so I actually can do that specific task.
Stop yelling. Do you understand me?
I'm not yelling. You're the one being a mental retard.
Mom, can you stop being so fucking retarded? I thought you were a little slow, you know, a little water-brained earlier because you didn't understand how those computer viruses worked, but apparently you don't know how to walk out a fucking doorway, Miss Government.
Oh, God.
You're
going
to regret.
Yeah, and one of these days, you're not going to have me. So same thing goes with you. Want me to tell you something, Mom? The funny thing is that you already lost yours. I don't even care if you wake me up early.
Do you want to get whacked again? Because that is how I have to respond to you. Is that what you want? For me to hit you?
I don't know. Do you want me to call child support?
Oh, God, I love how smug he sounded at the end of that one. You want me to smack you again? I don't know. You want me to call child support? He is gonna hold that over her ass for years. That is a fantastic example of a child who's decided they want total von Clausewitz style fucking warfare with their single mother. She's at a loss. Like, she doesn't get it. She doesn't understand why he's so pissed off when it's pretty fucking obvious what's made him that mad. Is this because I'm not with your daddy anymore? No. It's because you, embarrassed me, humiliated me about that masturbation thing, and now I have to destroy you. I have to take you apart piece by piece. Piece by piece, Mom. Piece by piece. Until there's nothing left, until they send child support to the house. And that's how it's going to end, Mom. Oh. What is it with kids playing video games and getting into arguments with their mothers? Here's another classic one. Maybe you've seen it, maybe you haven't. It's called, I've titled it, Poop Trouble. It's pretty fantastic. This is an amazing clip. A little different than the Roblox kid. A little bit of a different situation. Now, maybe if Dad was in the house, he would take a belt to this kid. But Mom is going to try to talk him into it. Let's see what she wants to talk him into. I present to you Poop Trouble.
Ah, Demetrius! Get off the game, go to the bathroom, and take a shit. Now.
Hey.
Bathroom and shit now. Go to the bathroom and take a shit. It's a smell. Get off.
Hey,
go to the bathroom.
Get out.
Go to the bathroom. I can smell you shitting yourself. Get up and go to the bathroom. Now.
No.
Get up and go to the bathroom.
Not yet. What the hell?
Go to the bathroom! You're shitting yourself!
Not yet. What the hell?
Go to the bathroom!
achievement points, Mom. No, I gotta finish the mission. I can't poop right now. Hey, Mom, come on, fuck up.
Bathroom, you're shitting yourself.
Not yet. No.
I will rip everything apart. I swear to God. Go to the bathroom.
Not yet.
You're shitting yourself.
Not yet.
You're shitting yourself. Poop is coming out of your fucking asshole. Go to the bathroom.
Not yet. What the
heck? Go.
Not yet. No.
Go to the goddamn bathroom.
No.
I don't want to go to the What? Oh, you walk by. He's playing Mafia 3, which is a shit game to begin with. Playing Mafia 3, just defecating on himself. He's so into this game. He's just can't constantly taking a big old deuce. Mom's trying to drag his teenage ass out of there. Oh, I don't want to go. No. Pee pee poo poo mama. No. She's got to like put a little trail attendees. Go into the bathroom, you know, like circle the toilet bowl with some chicken tenders from McDonald's, maybe, you know, lure them in. You know, trick them. You got to try to trap them like a deadfall trap with tendies. I don't know. How do you get your son to not shit himself? Oh, it's a great, you know, it's such a short clip. I want to play it again. I want to listen to it again. God, I love the internet.
Demetrius, get off the game, go to the bathroom, and take a shit. Now.
Hey.
Bathroom and shit now. Go to the bathroom and take a shit.
I like how dedicated he is. Because, like, she's yelling at him to take a poop and probably trying to, like, peel him off the chair. But he's still playing. Notice the gameplay footage doesn't stop.
I can smell you. Get off. Hey, go to the bathroom.
Get out.
Go to the bathroom. I can smell you shitting yourself. Get up and go to the bathroom! Now!
No.
Get up and go to the bathroom! Go to the bathroom! You're shitting yourself!
Like, what was he saving it up for? I'm kind of curious, like, what he says, not yet. Is it like a designated pooping time? Like, has he got it marked on a calendar? Is there a little alarm clock? Like, Demetrius poo time? Like, has he got that all set up and squared away? Mom doesn't understand? Like, Mom, come on. Not yet. It's not poop time yet.
Not yet.
Go to the bathroom. You're shitting yourself.
Not yet. No.
I will rip everything apart. I swear to God. Go to the bathroom!
Not yet.
You're shitting yourself!
Not yet.
You're shitting yourself. Poop is coming out of your fucking asshole. Go to the bathroom!
And this raises another interesting question. Now, clearly she probably smells it, but if she could see shit coming out of his asshole, I'm imagining an autistic 17-year-old completely naked in a gamer chair, squatted over it, defecating wildly as he is engrossed in Mafia 3. Can you imagine the sight?
Not yet.
Go!
Not yet. No.
Go to the goddamn bathroom.
Not
yet, no. It's poop trouble. Single mom's out there having some trouble. Tried to tard wrangle her son, can't get it happening. It's not happening. Of course, we have another bit of mommy rage here. Another one that involves a little bit of slapping. Another let's player. Doesn't involve pooping, not poop trouble.
What a piece of shit. Oh, look, he did it again. No, fucking, why do people tell me to fucking take a break when I'm doing good at games? You fucking shut your whore bag piece of shit cock-sucking mouths. Is what you fucking, I need to restart again.
Oh, do you remember these days, folks? Do you remember when YouTube used to be like this back in the angry video game phase? Where everybody wanted to be the AVGN so they'd throw in 18 cuss words in between every sentence? Just for no reason? Oh, the good old days.
I lost too many lives. I hit the continue button. I need to not hit the continue button. I need to game over first so I can actually continue from the start of the level.
Okay! Don't you fucking raise your voice to me. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Just from out of nowhere. It's like a primal tarn yell. Oh, you got to be careful with these boys in the video games. All right, Awesomenator will, eviscerate you with his logic misgovernment. But these other guys, they're either too busy pooping or they go into full tard rage. Just out of nowhere.
I need to game over first so I can actually continue from the start of level.
Mm-hmm. Okay! Don't you fucking raise your voice to me. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Slap me! Do it! Do it!
What is wrong with you?
Do it!
What is wrong with you?
Do it!
You want me to fucking slap you? I will.
Do it!
And this is why I don't play Rayman, all right? It leads to domestic violence. This is why I refuse to play Rayman, all right? It always leads to somebody getting slapped. Well, back it up. You can listen. It's the effects of playing this fucking game.
Don't you fucking raise your voice to me. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Slap me! Do it! Do it!
What is wrong with you?
Do it!
What is wrong with you?
Do it!
You want me to fucking slap you? I will.
Do it! I don't care.
Knock it off. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Fuck.
Oh, here comes the turkey noise.
Lot of fucking nerve. Lot of fucking nerve. Never raise your voice to me again. Can you understand?
Yep.
Stop it.
Oh, God. I don't know what happened. Like, okay, so did he hit her or did she hit him? But somewhere in there, a fucking turkey got loose.
Lot of fucking nerve. Never raise your voice to me again. Can you understand?
Yep.
Stop it.
And that's the second dad shows up. That's also the best part of it. Like, they're screaming like tards at each other. Second dad hears turkey noises. He's fucking off the couch.
God damn it. Stop it.
Hold on. I need to stop the stream. I need to stop my stream.
I need to turn off my stream. Son, you hit your mom so hard she made a turkey noise. I'm going to have to ask you to leave. I told you we'd let you live here if you paid rent, but once you make her gobble, that's it. You're out. I have my limits, too. Dad had to step in when the turkey noises began. Now, to round out our little fatherless section, I mean, we've looked at poop trouble. We've watched Awesomenator eviscerate Mrs. Government. We've listened to a Let's Player driven to rage by Rayman make his mother gobble like a turkey with his fist. Let's close that section out with one more. A blast from the past. We've seen clips of him before. I'm talking about our boy, Chibi Neko Demix.
Super backs.
Give me
ever.
Just a second. What?
You need to get off of it. Two people now showed up. Passport Pizza and Fred's. You need to shut this down. They see that you're on there. These kids see that you're on there, and they're pulling the same shit again.
Okay, so...
Do you see? Is there any way you can contact Facebook and tell them to block this bullshit?
No, there isn't.
Well, there's gotta be. There's gotta be a way to get on to call Google.
Listen, Chippy, we've got all these people calling me telling you're showing your tallywhacker to girls on the internet. Now they're ordering us fucking pizzas. This poor fucking woman. Oh, this poor fucking woman.
Facebook something, email them whatever, and tell them that they put your name and phone number on there and you need somehow to block it. We're going to lose our phone number because of this. Because I asked them, I said, what number did they call from? And they said they called from this number. You need to get off for the night. Thank God Dad isn't here.
That might be the problem, miss. The problem might be that Dad isn't there. Maybe the common theme in a majority of these previous clips is that Dad is not there. And that's why your autistic son is just constantly waddles into nonstop trouble is having pizzas delivered while he plays Mario Golf for whatever the fuck this is.
Because now I hear the phone beeping up there like someone's been calling in here too. So I can just hardly wait. He was pissed. The guy from Passport was really pissed.
You ever hear a pissed off Italian son? Kept talking about his pizza pies. I don't know what the fuck he was saying. Half of it was in Italian. Kept saying Mamma Mia. How ironic is that? You're playing a game with an Italian man and I'm getting screamed at by one on the phone. Stop Let's Playing. You're not going to be famous.
You know what? I'm going to have to call that policeman back again. That phone number on that card he gave you, and tell him that they're doing it again to you.
Wait, did she walk away and say motherfucker at the end? What was that? Hold on, let me back that up. She did, didn't she? Oh, let me raise the audio. Hold on, listen really carefully. I'm pretty sure she's like, motherfucker. Just my autistic son, motherfucker. Mamma mia.
Oh dear. What's happening?
I gotta go.
Alrighty, dude.
Cause, people are... Yeah, people just...
Yeah, I understand.
As soon as I went live, they started ordering pizzas, and like two or three pizza places have now tried delivering pizzas to us.
God, he's always getting into shenanigans. Oh, God. I don't even know what he's currently up to. I think he went overseas through the JET program or some shit. He was going to be like a teacher, and that blew up in his face, of course. And now he's like in a polycule? Like, have we not seen that turn into disaster? He's like dating a group, like, he's in a relationship with like a group of 12 people? Am I right on that? I don't really keep current on Chibi. I just wait for like the greatest hits to come out, and then I have a giggle watching them as they come out. Oh, what a life. God, I still remember first encountering him when he used to wear a dog collar and emo goth shit. And now he's in a polycule. Now he's in a polycule. Failed speedrunner, failed Let's Player, laughing stock of those communities. In a polycule. Dating smelly people. Smelly, smelly people. Somebody said he's trans, he's in a polycule. They dumped him? No, fuck off. They broke? You're kidding me. He's been rejected already? He was in the polycule for a week. He's been thrown out? Wow, I guess he really is a speedrunner. Congratulations. Chibi Necodemics takes the world record in getting thrown out of a polycule in just under 1 day, 3 hours, and 5 minutes. Round of applause. Let's get that up on the leaderboard. What websites still track speedruns? We need to get Chibi entered. He'll be number one in that position. Fastest person thrown out of a polycule, Chibi Necodemics. Adam White, come on down and accept your trophy. God! Brutally dumped by 12 people at one singular moment in time. Oh, I think his soul might implode. That's pretty great. Wow, he's still gotten in him. Good for you, buddy. Good for you. Oh. Well, I hope you've enjoyed our portion of the Father's Day thing. Went over Ben Thorpe. Went over Gene, the father of Jesse Slaughter. Looked at the results of fatherless children dealing with single mothers. But there's still some other things to talk about. Not really within the theme of Father's Day, but still, I think it must be touched on. Because I issued a warning on my last stream, and somebody didn't listen. Somebody didn't listen because they didn't take it seriously, and now they're facing the consequences. So let's just give everybody a reminder. Let's bring it up to speed. I gave somebody a warning and said, you're next, buddy. You're next. An evil, nefarious thing which lurks out in the ether, in the void, an intangible wickedness has set its sights on you, and you didn't listen. Should have listened. Why didn't you listen to the warning? In fact, you had to get cocky about it. You actually egged it on. You egged it on! He said, give me more, bad juju! Why would you do that? Why would you taunt her? It's the future you chose. You literally asked for it. Send me the medallion. The demon must be guarded. As Joshua's trying to make you wear the medallion. Shut up, you worthless lipcock. Why are you so angry? You're like, send me the medallion. I'm not even fucking kidding you. So, like, a week after I said, dude, there's some fucked up shit. Listen, Dick. There's some fucked up shit going on. Like, everybody in this group's been fucked with in a severe way. They've had horrible luck. You're like the last one. You're the last man out. And this fucking curse is coming towards you. And you were like, bring it on. Give it to me. Hit me with both barrels. And then Magic Chan locked and loaded that fucking gun, didn't she? Hit song from Magdalaska. I mean, come on. Let's be honest here, Dick. Do you really think it's a coincidence? After you taunted Magi-chan, after you begged for the medallion, your stunt boy gets arrested, gets locked up, gets put in cuffs. I've got some of the footage of the arrest and stuff. I'll play some. It's a mugshot. I'm not sure what happened to his eye. Is he winking? Has she possessed half of him? Is she sending you a message, Dick? This Magic Chan has possessed half of his body and she's winking at you? She's taunting you. This is half a possession. Get Chris Boers on the phone. We need his expertise. But here is Riley getting arrested.
Oh, you're being arrested? Oh! They're arresting a young Klippa. Oh, shit! Chad, he's being arrested!
Now, he got busted outside of, like, Eric July was doing like some comic event or some shit. He was out there doing whatever the fuck he's doing, ends up getting arrested. They take him into county lockup, but it's like a different county. I think he got like a high bail amount, but he got out somehow, like with bail and shit. I think it's like if they say, oh, you got to pay $10,000, you have to come up with like 10% of it, and then the bondsman covers the rest of it, as long as you have like collateral. I'm not 100% certain, but that's a rough idea of what I get. He's not locked up right now. It's my understanding he's actually out now. But this is him getting arrested. 1 week after I told you, Dick, don't taunt Magi-chan. And you're like, give me the medallion. I want the medallion. So I don't know how hard I need to impress this upon you. So I had AI help me, and I created a song. Maybe the song will convince you that you're in some deep shit and this demon is coming for you. And it's far too late.
From King, laugh and play. Time.
You should have listened. You should have listened to the warning. All that warning was coming in, but you weren't listening. Now you suffer the consequences. Riley's getting arrested. There are lawsuits apparently being filed against everybody. There's fights everywhere. It all went to shit once you said you wanted that medallion. All right, that's what I'm putting it on. That's what I'm pinning it on. She's coming for you, buddy. I'm not even kidding. You need to contact Chris Boers and hope that he can fix it. Hope that he's got that magical fucking power to fix it. All right, this is the second time. If you get hit by a bus or something, like a fucking plane explodes above your house, I'm telling you, I called that ahead of time. All right, I'm giving you fair warning about this magic chance shit. So we're all on the same page. I really felt that was necessary to bring up. I thought that was important. it's been a wild couple of months. You got Dick being hunted by a demonic spirit. You've got Ralph fading into the ether. I don't know what he's doing. Who cares? Who cares what Ralph does? Oh. What else? What else do we have? Oh, we've got Riqueta. Still waiting on that body cam footage. A little bit more of the reports that came out. You got some weird law tube shit. They've covered a lot of this over on the Kino Casino, so if you had a chance to watch them, you're probably up to date on the majority of it. Filthy dwelling is what the police report said. A lot of stories coming out from Aaron, Imaholt, talking about feeding the kids SpaghettiOs, and law tube saying the kids should have taken care of themselves, and that they were reported. Apparently, it was more than just one designated reporter. It was a bunch of people making complaints about the kids being hungry and starving. That's just not a great look. Now, what's going to happen with that? The body cam footage probably is going to shed more light on it. I have no idea. You know, the police report and Aaron and others have said that the house was in a pretty bad state. So when that body cam footage, if it gets released and it looks terrible, it's not a good look. Law tube's getting into its own little civil war. People flinging shit back and forth, threatening lawsuits against each other. Saw some really, really shady shit going on between the two different groups. So I'm sure that'll blow up into something. Again, Kino Casino's covering that more than I would. I've seen bits and pieces. Kind of waiting to see how this plays out and where it goes, to be honest with you. And then, of course, how could I forget Gator? Oh, Gator! Gator! Oh, I gotta talk about Gator and the VTubers! Apparently there's been a big kerfuffle about VTubing. As Gator tried to fuck a VTuber, went to an anime convention. Apparently this VTuber's got like a fetish list full of eating and huffing shit and lollies and all this other crazy fucking crap. it's your Mimenko moment, Gator. This is your Mimenko moment. This is you riding that horse, Gator. You're riding that horse. It's dummy mommy time, Gator. Oh, God, Gator. Yeah, it's pretty bad luck. I don't know who Kiki is, as far as VTubing goes. I mean, I've learned a bit about Kiki. Apparently. I learned a little bit about Kiki. But apparently, somehow, Gator doing this has entangled me into this. And now I must make a declarative statement about Pippa Pipkins and Kirsch and VTubers in general. Because they've made some edgy jokes. And apparently they're raging pedophiles, is what I've been told. And I must disavow them. I'm not going to disavow them. Sorry, not going to disavow them. I like anime and I like VTubing. And I don't think Pippa Pipkins or Kirsch are pedophiles. And I don't think they're into weird, fucked up shit. I think they make edgy fucking jokes and meme like a majority of people do. I could be wrong. And if somebody comes forward with evidence, or if they make a statement that's really heinous, sure. I have something to say on that. But I'm not going to throw them under the bus. Because Gator got a boner because some chick likes to eat shit. Or whatever the fuck it is that Kiki's into. I don't know. I don't know what... it's supposed to be bad, though. It's supposed to be really bad. Gator, you got to make a statement on this. All right? You gotta come forward and talk about it. I've been dredged up to talk about it. So I'm curious. You know, another thing I'm curious about, coincidentally, as I had warned Dick a week or so ago, About 3 or 4 weeks back, there's a very interesting occurrence that happened in the VTubing world. There happened to be a persona that suddenly showed up and tried doxing a bunch of them. Tried doxing a bunch of them and saying a lot of heinous shit to try to basically sink them. And it's really weird because I made these statements. Made these statements about this. You can kind of read along. But basically the gist of it was me explaining that VTubing makes a lot of money. It's ludicrous amount of money from merchandise and super chats. And that it's only a matter of time until a bunch of assholes decide that they're going to try to hone in on it and make long-form videos and exposés to cash in on some of those VTube and dollar redos. And what do you know? What do you think happens, like, in a week of me saying this and this event playing out? Oh, here comes Ethan Ralph to declare total VTuber death. Total VTuber death! Ethan Ralph, he's going to take them down. Oh, he's coming to take down the VTubers, just like he took down America First. For a whole week at a time before it completely petered out and nobody gave a shit. Holy shit. Folks, there are a lot of fucked up people out there. I mean, we've watched. I've shown you clips of massively fucked up individuals. We just watched Ben Thorpe, for God's sake. All right, you saw this. I'm going to need a little more. If you want me to disavow people, like Pippa or Kirsch or whoever the fuck it is, and really slam them down, you're going to need to give me more than shit cut out of context or edgy jokes. I mean, I need some real deal shit. As far as Kiki goes, it seems pretty fucked up. Sure hate to be Gator! Because that Dommy Mommy riding the wooden horse shit's it's a bad look. I'm not sure why. I don't know what the fuck to tell you, man. I'm looking forward to Gator's statement on this. It's going to be fun to listen to, isn't it? Oh, was that a shit fetish? Chat, can you walk me through this? I'm kind of half paying attention. I know Lolly was one of the big allegations that was thrown in there. There was pee, I'm pretty sure. There's a little poo-poo. There's a little poop time involved in this. I'm waiting for chat to catch up. Obviously, there's a delay. Yes, anime is base chat. That is very true. But I'm waiting. Was it poop or pee? It was some fucked up shit. I probably should have listened to Matt at the internet. I think Josh covered this. It was ToddlerCon? Is that what somebody said? Was the Kiki was into ToddlerCon? I thought it was poop and piss and lolly. See, now we're just going wild with rumors. Which was it exactly? Oh, that's going to be hard to go. Oh, God damn, Gator. Oh, you're literally standing on a minefield. Holy shit. Any movement to any side is going to be disastrous. You're catching up with me, chat. People are saying it was Tyler. God, holy fuck. Dude. Oh, I'm trying to think, what would your PR answer to that be? How do you talk your way out of that one? You're going to have to use, what was it Ben Thorpe said? The Greek sense of it? Gator, is that what you're going to say? Say ToddlerCon in the Greek sense of it. Oh, you're moving too quickly for me, chat. God damn it. You know, maybe somebody can tweet it to me. Could you tweet it? Could you tweet it specifically to me? Somebody said, is there a chat summary now? Where are you guys getting the AI shit from? Chat summary. Apparently auto-generated. Quality may vary. No shit. The chat is discussing the controversy surrounding streamer and VTuber Gator. People are sharing the negative opinions on him, as well as alleged support of a streamer named The Gunt, who was accused of abusing his cat. I think the AI might have got a little weird. Okay, somebody said she was rating fetishes. So was this a gag or was it real? Because I don't know fucking shit about Kiki. No, we got something about Chibi. You know what? I guess I'll have to wait. I'll have to wait with bated breath for what Gator's statement is. Isn't he releasing a statement? Has Gator released his statement yet? I don't know why the cat's involved. I don't know why the AI thinks the cat's fucking involved. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Somebody sent me something. VTuber Gator talks to, in the video, talking about their favorite fetish being Lolicon and how they like to pretend to be the child. They pulled a moot? She wants to be the little girl? Is that what you're telling me? I'm looking. I'm also double checking if there's the Gator statement yet. If he's released his political statement on how he's going to walk out of this one. I don't think it's happening. Yeah, sorry to disappoint. But anyway, back to the main point. I like anime, and I like manga, and I like VTubers, and they're always going to be fucked up people in any sort of community, and you should laugh at them and mock them. And if that turns out to be Kiki and Gator, then laugh and mock away all you want. But as far as Pippa and Kirsch go, I haven't seen anything that's extraordinary to me yet. Sorry. There's no disavow if that's what you're hoping for. Jimmy stands firm on this. I don't really care. You're going to have to give me something of substance to make me go, oh. Until then, I like the little rabbit. The little fox. They're fine. As far as Kiki and Gator, best of luck. Best of luck. Holy shit. Oh, it's still checking here. Still checking to see if somebody can send it to me. All I know is the VTuber was rating fetishes and said they really like Lolicon shit. It was their number one fetish, apparently, and how they wanted to be the child. Let's see. Null accused Pippa and Kirsch being pedos when he covered that VTuber as well. Yeah, but then I heard that he retracted that. What is it? Kiki did a hentai tag rating stream and pee-pee poo-poo was unusually high. Gator released a statement that he's being sacrificed to the corn. Oh, we've got a clip here. Let's see. Oh my god, are they Australian? Let me see if I can, hold on, chat. I'm going to see if I can pull the volume up so you can hear this too. I know you're not seeing the video of it, but I don't know what's going to flash on screen. Could be like a trap. So I'm not going to like put it up on screen and then there's something horrible that gets shown. So let's listen to this audio together. This is sent to me. This is apparently the, this is the pee-pee poo-poo stream. Let's listen in.
I just kind of like it though. I'm like, it's alright. I don't know. Okay, listen. Listen, as someone...
Oh, god damn it. Hold on, sorry.
I just kind of like it, though.
Is it coming through, the volume?
Right. I don't know. Good. Okay, listen. As someone that's done teaching before, I find the whole thing a little uncomfortable.
As what?
As someone that's done teaching before...
Okay, so this is from Matt at the internet. Is this Josh watching this? So wait, the pee-pee poo-poo streamer's a teacher?
As someone who's done teaching before, chat.
I find the whole thing a little uncomfortable. Like, a little bit. Like, I've done teaching before in my life. I used to teach, I had a little bit where I was teaching kids, primary school children, like, little.
Oh, what the fuck? Why would you, first off, right? Why would you do a fetish rating stream where you talk about pee-pee poo-poo and liking little girls? And then followed up by saying, by the way, I was a teacher that had access to young children. In what logical world would you think that would ever be a smart decision to put those two statements together?
Kids? Almost like, I don't know.
Gator literally lurks on fucking VTuber. And he found that this bitch posts on fucking VT, and he thinks he has a chance with her. And that is why he watches her, because she is like a small time. She has like 15,000 followers on fucking YouTube or something. He thinks he actually has a chance with her and shows up in person at these conventions to say hello. And even she, a fucking pedophile who openly fantasizes about little girls being raped, sees Gator in public and sighs with agony that she has to talk to him. Yes, I know who you are. Gator You have fallen lower than anything. You are not even liked by a pedophile on the fucking internet. They can't even pretend to tolerate you, Gator. It's time to give up.
Oof. Oh, oh, that one stings a little. Do not show this, Jim, but holy fuck. Well, I'm not going to click it then. Don't send me something and say, don't show this. It's horrible. Well, yeah, no, I don't think so. Here's the stream that kicked it off. Okay, so is this a legitimate stream? Let me ask you. Or is this somebody, are they trying to meme? Is this some shitty copypasta that they're doing? Or is this actually like a tier video where they're like, this is really what I'm into? This is actually what I'm into. She said she likes characters with no womanly features, likes molestation hentai, and is a massive lolicon. Oof. Oof. Well, listen, I have to disavow. I'm sorry. Sorry, but if you've got proclivities towards kids, and you've got access to them through teaching, that's a completely different ballpark, isn't it? I mean, it'd be hypocritical of me not to find that fucked up. And my entire point of not liking Ross, remember Bathtub Ross, was the fact that he had access to fucking kids. You know, he said all this outrageous shit. And then he's like, oh, also I want to volunteer at schools. No. No. Fuck no. No, stay the fuck away from schools. You don't get to go to schools. And now you got this particular person out there making fetish tier lists. And if it's not some kind of shitpost or copypasta, talking about how they want, you know, like molestation and little girls, and they're a teacher? Yeah, that's a fucking problem. Gator! That would be a fucking issue. Gator! What are you doing? That would be a fucking issue. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh. Pinned comment has all the timestamps. Deleted stream. Let me get you the link. Okay, I think I get the gist of it. Thank you for the people that actually sent me links to shit. That I get a chance to look at this. I was looking for the Gator statement if he's released one yet. I don't see it. Maybe he will. Maybe he won't. Holy fuck. So that's been your month. It's like little fucking infernos everywhere. People getting arrested. People threatening lawsuits. Terrible shit coming out. Disavowals, little wars taking place, civil war is taking place. It's lunacy. The last 2 months have been fucking lunacy. I didn't even talk about Sneeko getting his teeth knocked out of his fucking mouth. I think there's so much shit going on. My little father's saying, you know, it's going to be a little kind of quiet closer. I didn't even get to really talk about Sneeko getting fucking punched in the face by probably the most video game-like hit I've ever seen in my life. Gamers won. Somebody in chat, gamers won, Jim. Gamers won. Oh, yeah. You know what? Let me see. Maybe I can find the Sneeko video. Let me find you the Sneeko video. I can at least show you that. Because it's like a minute of him getting punched in his fucking face. Just getting smacked around. I mean, if I had to give you... Okay, let me see if I can find that. I want the actual video of him just getting fucking cold cocked. Almost got it. I've got to dig through timelines. I'm looking through timelines here. Hold on, almost there. FPAC was a massive shit show. So apparently, I'll bring you up to speed as I'm looking for the clip. So Nick Fuentes decides to hold the America First PAC conference, like the fourth one of them, out in Detroit. They get a venue. The venue ends up canceling on them. So then they go to like an after party, and the after party ends up canceling on them. And then they decide to fuck with the security guard. And Sneeko's there, and he's fucking with the security guard. And the security guard, I swear to God, basically does, like, I'm sorry, let me at least get a fucking picture of it. You know what, this is good enough, this sums it up well enough. You know, sure, that'll do, let me put this into OBS so you can get a good look. You have to fucking see it. It's really, I can't do it justice trying to explain it without actually showing it to you. Called this Sneeko Gets Slapped. So they're at this after party. After party's like, you got to get the fuck out of here. We want you gone. They decide to fuck with the security guard. They like, they knock his hat off his head for some reason and start chanting, fuck you, Adam, and all this stuff. And I guess, like, you know, he decided, ah, you know what? Not today. Not today, friend. Today, I'm gonna just cold cock the shit out of you. Now, hopefully that shows up on stream. On the left side is the security guard. Now, the angle you're looking at right now is him literally leaping through the air. It was the fastest reaction. It was like some Injustice-level fighting game shit. He fucking leaps through the air and Superman punches. Superman punches, like, flies through the air, like Kung Fu. It's like Matrix shit. And just fucking cold cocks him. And if you look over on the right side, that's Sneeko missing parts of his teeth. Because they got knocked down his fucking mouth by the security guard who has just decided to play a real-life version of Mortal Kombat with him. Decided he had enough. He was going to teach him a lesson. Some DBZ shit happening out in the middle of fucking Detroit. Apparently that's not the only... Like, this guy, like, took out, like, three or four of them. Like, he went full in. I highly recommend looking at the video. It's, like, 30 seconds long. It's funny as shit. Now, of course, immediately after this, Sneeko decides to call the police and starts talking about lawyering up and suing. So, who knows where that's going to go? All I know is, does this dude generally pay for the privilege of this? Sneeko's the one that let his girl get fucked in front of him, right? That's Sneeko? Am I thinking the right guy? The dude that sits in the cuck chair? It's hard to keep track. There's so fucking many at this point. Like, you could name a podcaster, and chances are they watch their girlfriend get fucked by somebody else. But I'm pretty sure he usually pays for it. Like, this must have been, that's why he's smiling. He got punched by a big, muscular black man. That's why he's smiling. He saved himself some money. Got it for free this time. People say, yep, that's him. Cuck chair. Okay, yes, that's the right, I'm thinking of the right person. How are you going to let your girl get fucked and watched, bro? What are you doing? Oh, what if the security... you know what? I'm not going to... I'll cut it there. Cut it there. I've been highly offensive tonight already. Highly offensive already. But like I said, it's a lot of crazy shit going on. You got all the stuff with Masterson and Riley in July going on, all the LawTuber Civil War shit going on, all the VTuber stuff going on. You got fucking AFPAC with Nick and Sneeko and fucking fist fights going on. It's just, it's been wild. It's been a wild couple of months. I know this is weird. It's weird to end off a Father's Day stream talking about unrelated things, but I don't know. Maybe if all of these people had better fathers or fathers at all, none of these problems would exist. I don't know. I don't know. I blame misgovernment. I blame Awesome Nader's mother. That's who I blame for all this shit. It's her fucking fault. But I think we'll close out the stream here. Now, I've got super chats to read through from Ko-Fi and Cash App. I will definitely get to those. We're going to take a small break. I'm going to grab a drink because my throat's killing me at the moment. Read through those and then close it out. Otherwise, to the normal people out there, have a happy Father's Day. I'm sure it doesn't involve any of this crazy kind of shit. I'm sure you have a normal life. It's nice to look at the wild side every once in a while and see all the crazy fucking stuff that's taking place. I wish I could have worked CRP in here somehow. If I'd done an I Am Alex segment, I could have got him in because he had a dog quote and I love playing that dog clip, but didn't have the time. It'll always be there though. It's my favorite video clip and I will use it as much as I can. So I've got that fucker locked and loaded. He's ready to go for future use at some point, if there ever is. But yeah, so everybody that came out, enjoy the rest of your Sunday evening. Enjoy the rest of your Father's Day. Everybody else wants to stick around for the Super Chats. We're going to do a small break. When I come back, we'll hit them and then close it out. So let me just put on the break thing, put on the break music, and give it about 5 minutes, and I'll be right back. Thank you. Okay, all right, we're back. So I will go through the Cash App and Ko-Fi things here. We'll start off with the Cash App for everybody to suck around. Get to the Super Chats here. Just give me 1 second. Let me pull this up. All right. Some of these I've already... Oh, there we go. Okay. Sorry, folks. Just boomering it up. From Evan, happy Father's Day, Jim. Well, thank you very much. From Jaeger, praying someday you get to celebrate Father's Day. Not looking like a likely outcome. From Sneed, did you hear that Bossman got permabanned on Kick? Yes, I did. Apparently, he fucked up some... He had some crazy deal with Stake.com or Kick or something. I almost can't believe the money amount I was hearing. It was some crazy shit like $14,000. Was it a week? Or a month? It was a ridiculous amount of money, right? It must have been a month. It has to have been a month. It couldn't be a week. But he had some lucrative deal set up or some kind of a negotiated thing that was set up with a gambling site and the website, and everything was looking rosy. And then he got kicked off, and now he's over on Twitch. Is that it? That's got to suck. Imagine that kind of money within your grip, and then it's gone. Well, I mean, it is Bossman, so so I guess it makes sense that that would happen. Of course that's going to happen to him. Oh, we got one from Chris here. Thank you for the stream, Father Jim. Stay healthy. Well, thank you very much. From Steven. Natters and Fillion are pretty entertaining VTubers. From Jab. FYI, Riley was arrested because of tweets. Tweeting in the first degree. From Daniel. Love you, Jim. Thanks for all the help. Glad I could help. From Johnny. Grace broke Baldo on that beer to prevent stains. From Tortafan. Aren't we all Tortafans? Don't we all just love tortas? From Tortafan. How do you think AI will affect gay ops and trolling? Oh, I think it's going to make it catastrophically devastating for everybody. Are you kidding me? Holy shit. From Super Sasha X. For a virus caused me to, a virus caused me to drop my pants, masturbate. What a horrible moment. That kid is going to remember that forever. From Lauren. Hi, Jim. Can we get a Will is gay? Thanks, dude. Well, Will is gay. There you go. For your $20 reduce. From Jackson. Here's a fiver for me, Jim. Thanks for the laughs. Well, you're very welcome. From Heather. Glad you returned from the store. Well, I'm glad to be back from the store. At least today of all days. From Elijah. Tell my wife Ashley to come back. Ashley, you need to come back. Elijah is waiting. Though not waiting impatiently or waiting too much because he only gave me $1 for that. From Sig. Okay, I've read that one. That was a Gary Plunch Energy. Some of these I have gone through, so I'll try to make sure I don't double do them. From Neil. Hey, Jim. Tell Neil to pick up his goddamn phone. Neil, this was a while ago, so I don't know if Neil's going to be near his phone anymore. There's chances that he's just completely fucked off, and now we're not going to know. Again, from Neil. Please tell my friend Herbie Aruga. Arugaru. Oh, there you go. From Ryan. Oh, this was the stalker child. Enjoy your freedom. I always enjoy my freedom. Big Libby. Can you call my friend Wyatt a gay weeb? Love you. Well, Wyatt, you are a gay weeb. There you go. From Reese. And it's for a bunch of emojis. There's something there. From Sean. Shekels for the hat god. Well, thank you very much. From Kenny. Glow in the dark. I can't say that last word. It's prohibited on this website. From Jalen. That was the one about NNRU. I've got one from Mark here. Is it Tanner Jimbo? God bless you and Jane. I think I've read that one earlier. That was the Jimco one. Okay. I'm caught up on Cash App. Let me go over to Ko-Fi here because that's where the majority of the messages usually are. Let me just refresh here and we'll get to them. Can somebody in chat tell me how much was it? Was it, you know, before I get into these, was it actually $14,000? Or was that just complete bullshit? Because that's a ridiculous amount of money. I mean, was that money he was supposedly going to be given to gamble with? Was that like the agreement? Like, we'll give you, what would that even work out to? It's like $3,000 a week. We'll give you $3,000 a week to gamble with. Is that what it was? $14 million. Yeah, $14 million. And they decided to go all in with them. Oh, devastating. People saying, yes, it was 14K. Somebody saying it was 4K a week is what it basically worked out to. 14K to gamble. So how does that work then? They give him the money to gamble. It's like store credit. But if he wins, does he get to keep it? Was that the agreement? Was that kind of like the deal? Like, oh, if you win with the money, we'll let you keep it, but you have to gamble it knowing that he's always going to gamble and lose. Yeah, somebody said, are there more super chats? Yes, there are. I'm just taking a break to try to... I'm trying to figure out how much money Bossman Jack was actually getting. $14,000 per week to gamble. Holy shit, that's fucking crazy. Oh, actually, you know what? I should put this up so people know what the fuck's going on. Sorry, hold on. There we go. Okay, somebody wanders into the stream and like, what the fuck is going on here? It's Super Chats. Super Chats is going on here. There we go. Okay, let me pull up Ko-Fi. From Have You Seen Kyle? Love you, Jim. Thanks for the laughs. Well, appreciate it. From Abongo My Delongo. Any video game that stood out to you from the not E3 weekend? Fuck. I mean, there were a couple of, you know, PlayStation had like Souls-like games or like two of them. I don't even know what the fucking names of them were. I just generally like those games. Xbox had a, you know, like Doom looked good. Gears, if they don't fuck it up, looks like it could be good. That's about it. There wasn't a ton of shit, I'll be honest. You know, like, the majority of gaming stuff that's been shown off hasn't been super impressive. There have been a few good-looking games. There are a few, you know, some stellar-looking shit, I guess, that occasionally pops out, but on the whole, not a lot. Not a lot. From Carlo, happy Father's Day to you, Cancer Man. Also, shout-out to Suvarok. He makes watching the Killstream fun and entertaining. I agree. Everybody loves TTS. Everybody loves those bots. From Camilio, this is a Christian DBZ episode. Maybe I'll check it out later. From a down CBR. Hey, Jim, have you heard A Xenotype by Liam Gray? It's a Guyver-inspired manga. Yes, somebody sent me a copy, actually. I have a copy. Somebody's very nice to send me a copy. From Soap Boy, for our dads, any quick thoughts on Clint Saunders and Cooking with Jack? Not really. Not a ton. From I Love the Federal Government, Sneed. From Howieman, out of all the psychos you've covered over the years, which one disgusted you the most? Oh, I don't know. I mean, Bathtub Ross or Nick Bate were pretty fucked up. But the one I really disliked was that dentist. There was a dentist who would basically scam insurance. But the way he stole money was he'd perform unnecessary surgical procedures on kids without anesthesia. So he'd tell the parents, we're going to do a bunch of extractions or put in fillings or put in crowns and wouldn't use any anesthesia whatsoever. So he'd strap down like 3 or 4 or 5 year olds to a table and then he'd rip their teeth out and drill into their gums and shove metal and shit in there because he could charge for the anesthesia he didn't use and make a few extra bucks. And he did that to hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of kids. And never served a day in jail, by the way. Got away with it. He lost his license, but he never went to jail. And I don't think they were able to sue him in civil court either. So it's just a shitty fucking story all around. I'm going to be honest with you. From just as Ko-Fi supporter, Ono Rarikon. From Smilugian. Jim, do you know the game show Gumbo, a.k.a. Robert Seidelman? He's this fat troon who went to Evergreen College and spends all his time shitting on game shows. Okay, let me think about this for a minute. Evergreen College, was that the one where they had, it was almost like a month-long bullshit protest where they, because of the was it the Jewish professor? I can't remember his name. But he had said something about like they were going to do a day on campus where they made all the white people go away. And he's like, hey, that's kind of fucked up. And so they had like a month-long protest. If you're talking about, they're these two black dudes, they're both trans, and there's like this little miniature mini-me one in a wheelchair. If that's the dude you're talking about, yeah, I do think I know who you're talking about. From Brock the Rock, glad to see you're still kicking, Jim. Easter's room was great. A lot of horsing around. Here's a video of Jared Genesis from Cheems. Shout out my friend Laser Pig. He's a big hissed YouTuber. He likes to put his boyfriend into a sleeping bag with lube and carry him around pretending to be his Vordim. He's really committed to the bit, is he? From Rav Massage. Base Jim, thank you for resting your reputation on Pippa and Kirsch. Pippa may be a dummy, but Kirsch is an open book, and I'm happier a man who is slow to Hold on. We've got to pull the full one up. Slow to judge. And now it's reset me. So now I've got to scroll back down. I wish they made this a little easier to do. From Mr. Doggernuts, thanks for all the years of entertainment. Jim, the IGN speed dating stream you did years ago helped me cheer up through a rough time. Cheers. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. From Jinx, people need to learn to differentiate reality from fiction. Lolly's not cheese pizza. And normies are cancer for thinking so. What's your opinion, Daddy Jim? Well, I am not into Lolly. Nor am I into cheese pizza. So I'm staying over on this side. I'm staying, here's Jimmy over here. I'm going to let Gator take those kind of questions. Good luck, Gator. Oh, by the way, you know what? Let me tell you one second. Let me pull it up. Has Gator made his statement yet? Has he made his fucking statement yet? Nobody. Gator hasn't made a statement, has he? Has Gator got into witness protection? I don't think Gator's coming back. I want the PR statement. Let me refresh. Sorry, just give me a second, chat. I know you can't see what I'm doing. I'm checking Twitter. No, of course not. There's no statement. There's no fucking statement. Of course not. Why would there be? Okay. From Craig, that song is a certified hood classic. I hear Yee was involved. From Joshua Kuhn, Josh Spurs out over the Phantom anime pedophiles because of his internal guilt over his Fujashi tear posts about his love of Shota back in the day. From Phantasm, chat, make Jim, Father Metokur, the patron saint of internet humor. The Catholic Church will make money selling medallions, but only will ever known him as Jim. From Richard, hey Jim, you played One Turkey Noise video. Can we get a quick view of the fat hot dog eating gobbler? I don't remember his name. Get better, boss. That was Acerthorn. And I believe, I don't even know if I have access to the video. I think he's in the middle of like 12 lawsuits. Is he actually suing Josh too? If I remember right, I think he's also now suing Kiwi, or maybe it was a poster on Kiwi Farms. I don't know. Listen, this guy can file. He's got, I don't know what it's called. Popper something or other. But essentially, you know, when you go to file like a civil lawsuit, you have to pay money, right? Like it costs money. You get a lawyer and you do all this shit. Paperwork costs money. But he has like some kind of weird legal status where he doesn't have to pay, apparently. So he can just file lawsuit after lawsuit after lawsuit, just over and over and over again against fucking everybody. And I believe he's currently engaged in lawsuit 9,000 at this point. Okay, no, I've read that one. Why is it doubling back here? Hold on, folks. Okay. From Juju the Cow, that Magic Chan song was defamation. What do I know? Just a lot of lawyers. Uh-oh. Looks like I'm on the shit list. From Koala Dante, if only Bob had found the strength to chop down Chris's internet, iDubbbz put on the medallion. Nick put on the medallion. Dick somehow managed to complete the ritual. Oh, that's right. iDubbbz did wear a Chris Chan medallion, didn't he? He's asking for trouble. He's asking for fucking trouble. From Helmet Boy, cheers, big man. Hope you've sold a lot of hats tonight. Oh, I hope so, too. I hope so. There are only so many hats you can sell, let's be honest. Eventually, I'm going to run out of hats to sell. Eventually, there's going to be no more. Everybody's going to have a hat. There's just, you buy a hat for your hat, and then, you know, what, do you buy a hat for that hat? I mean, it's cute for the first couple of hats, but after a while. Is this why somebody else is bringing up? Ghost says, Jim, you promised us a tit beast hat. If you can make Breaking Baldo hat, you can definitely make a tit beast hat. That's such an in-joke from such a long time ago. I'd sell one of them. I'd sell a tit beast hat. Nobody, like, that's stream me. Maybe 20 people remember that. From Claude Seed, I remember the poop trouble video. I also remember that the kid that actually made a video about the embarrassing stream and called it, I kind of want to die. Oh, did he? What's that? He had a limit to it, did he? Captain Matt, thanks for the good times. Here's a pack of smokes. At a gas station coffee, I'm going to need a lot of whiskey to cope with what I've heard tonight. From the Clam Slam, Sweet Squad Unite, default user. Prednisone is a hell of a drug, Jim. RA and type 2 suck in my case, but I can't imagine what you're going through. Godspeed. Yeah, it's not fun. From David Davidson, Yo Jim, all my hats already have hats, but I really want that black zipper hoodie. That ever going to go back in stock? Maybe. It should be under one of the subheadings. If you look around and click, it's somewhere in there under apparel. I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure it's somewhere in there. From Kalako, thanks for the stream, Jimbo. Next pack of smokes on me. Well, thank you very much. From Thunder, no message on that one for some reason. Jaybird, fellow Jim here. Someone in real life told me that they think I'm a younger version of you. I nearly died a few years ago, Guillain-Barré syndrome. And now I'm my mid-20s. Oops, hold on, let me pull up the whole thing here. Struggling with long-term complications. Any advice on being frustrated with being the sick person? Fuck. You and I are in the same boat. I don't know what to tell you. It just sucks, doesn't it? Not that I've had Guillain-Barré. I hear that sucks quite a bit. I don't know. Get a hobby that you can lose yourself into. I mostly read, and I do, like, model kits. And I actually wanted to get into doing, like, dioramas. Like, I like Gunpla stuff because it's pretty bang for your buck. Like, you can buy, like, a Gunpla kit, right? And it's maybe 20, 30 bucks, and you get, like, 10 hours out of that. 5-10 hours, depending on how complicated it is, what it is exactly. And, you know, so I got into that. It definitely, I guess, helps, if that's what you're asking, to take your mind off being the sick person. But I wanted to get, like, dioramas. Like, if I've got these, like, Gunpla things. Because I've watched people do, like, dioramas on YouTube. And, like, people do crazy shit. And it's always, like, made out of, like, fucking styrofoam and cardboard, some glue, fake grass, and, like, a paint gun. So, like, the overall cost is, like, 40 bucks. But they're, like, making works of art and shit. And I get it. It's going to look like just dog shit the first 100 fucking times. But I want to try to get into that. Then I can put my little Gunpla models on there. Have little mech battle scenes with shit getting destroyed. My little cardboard cities being lit on fire. So that would be my advice. Is find a hobby that works for you. Okay, let me do this. Sorry, I'm trying to make sure I get to everybody's message, but every time I go in depth to read one, it fucking restarts me because fuck me. Ecstasy of thinking. Remember that Ethan Ruff got cucked by Ben Thorpe when he tried to serve her his micro Memphis? The new Doom looks fine. What are your thoughts on the Warhammer 40K? Warhammer 40K what? Drama with the pedos, troons, and female custodes. Look, Warhammer 40K is in a tenuous position. Just because, like, their models and shit are a ridiculous price. I'm not into the models for this in particular, but I've watched enough videos and heard enough people talk about it. And, like, the big conversation that seems to be going on to me right now, like, for Games Workshop and all this shit, is why would somebody spend a ridiculous amount of money getting a few pieces, a few figures for their army, when they could just buy a 3D printer and get the schematics and fucking make their own? Or go on Etsy and buy it because somebody else did it. And so they're getting, you know, 5 or 10 figures for 40 bucks rather than one, like, Battle Wagon for 140 or whatever the fucking ridiculous price is. Like, Warhammer 40K, like, you know, the tabletop, that kind of stuff. It's not great. It's not, I don't know. As far as, like, the drama going on, you're talking about with the lore, I haven't really been paying super deep attention, to be honest with you. I don't know what to tell you. Listen, everybody's trying to find a way to save a buck. And yeah, their prices are ridiculous. I haven't really even looked at, like, collectible card game shit lately, but I would imagine, like, stuff like Magic the Gathering and Yu-Gi-Oh! And that kind of stuff, that's probably getting priced out too. Like, people, maybe that's getting a little too rich for people's blood. I don't know. The economy's kind of shit. When the economy's kind of shit, you probably don't want to piss off your customer base. I mean, look at movies, look at video games, look at television shows. People just choose not to consume, and then everybody's losing their shirts and firing half the company. So maybe not the best time to piss off everybody. And didn't Cavill, like, walk? Wasn't he going to do some project with them? And he walked? I don't know. I wish I was more up to date on this for you so I could give you a better answer, but I can't, because I'm not super informed. So you're getting a sloppy opinion. I'm sorry. Oh, let's see here. Too bad. Found out about you from Awesome Nader. Nice to see him back on your stream again. Hope he's out there living the life as an alpha chad. From Krog, watching this on a treadmill and ate shit laughing. All the best, Jim. You deserve it. From Sprawl Jam, horrifying stuff, Jim. Excellent stream. God bless you and Jim. From Michael, thanks for all the entertainment over the years. Can you please tell Gabriel to go fuck himself? Well, Gabriel, that was $3 from Michael telling you to go fuck yourself. From Zero Sketch, check out the demo for... Okay, now I think I've actually looped back on where I was. From Unamo, hey, Jim. Skull to Voice is real, and they told me to stop being anti-Semitic. The FBI government circled us in a helicopter after my dad and I walked out of our doctor's appointment. Well, isn't that what the... what is it? The Havana effect? Wasn't there some shit going on where all these different government officials from the United States were saying that they were like having their minds scrambled by some ultrasonic device being used by foreign governments? Was it like the Havana effect or something like that? I can't remember the exact term. Is that what we're talking about? Wait till that shit gets on the street. That'll be fun. To Sequoi for you. Hey, Jim. Thanks for the show. I hope you're doing well. Look forward to you rising from the ashes like an autistic phoenix. From Bing Bong. Crazy how the least insane rightoid Aesleb is a practicing occultist who looks like a cryptid told in Warsh cape paintings. Apparently, he's still with his wife. From Will Filbert. Big fan. I'm so glad you finally attend a live stream. Did you see DSP watching porn on his stream today? Yes. Those clips are up on Twitter right now. Chat, if you go look, DSP got bamboozled. I guess somebody tricked him into watching some pornography on his fucking stream. Unless it was really good editing. It might have been really good editing. But if that's the clip you're talking about, yes, I did see it. It's like 10 seconds long. From Flash, happy Father's Day, Jim. Big Daddy, Jim. Now, if you excuse me, I have a wood chipper I need to prep. From Amber, yay, Jim. Glad you're inspired today. Happy Father's Day to all the non-shitty dads, and hugs to everyone missing their fathers. From Evan Ego, Mr. Medicare, been watching for years, but can finally afford to donate. Best of luck with the cancer aids, and keep making the rage pig holler. Well, thank you very much. From Little Jimmy, hi, Jim. Can't wait for the Magijan curse to fully take dick. Should be bountiful, harvest soon. Hoprakeda is watching so he can buy a mug of his mug. You know what? Again, I feel like it's just, it's important to me that Dick understands how dangerous this situation is. fuck it. I'm going to play the song again because I like it and we're never going to hear it again anyway. So, I mean, I might as well get, listen, this Suno AI shit, this AI stuff in general is pretty great. Isn't there a new program? Is it Luma that people are using on 2D pictures and it makes 3D video out of it? It's fucking wild. I still remember when, the first fake AI chat bots for, Jordan Peterson came out, 3 years ago. And people thought that was, the craziest shit ever. And now you've got AI writing songs and singing them. And you've got AI, animating 2D pictures into full fucking 3D objects. It's fucking lunacy. Somebody, one of the super chats earlier was how is that going to affect trolling? Oh, it's going to be catastrophic. Oh, it's going to be fucking devastating. Just fucking devastating. But anyway, since we're talking about the curse, I'm going to play the Magic Jam song one more time, and then I'll finish up the rest of the Super Chats, and we'll call it an evening. So let's pull her up, boys. Oh, well, let me make sure it actually fucking plays. Let's pull her up, and then it's dead silence. Good going. Here we go.
And play. Sometimes
Okay, there's our little Magic Jan song, and I just saw this. I saw the super chat, and you're right. Somebody said from Celius, don't forget about JF Gearpy, such a great father, taking care of his kids after his wife mysteriously disappeared. I probably should have worked a segment in for that. Fuck, I completely forgot. You know what? It would have actually fit in perfectly. I completely fucked that one up. From Anna, Tyler is a squish. These streams are one of the few things I look forward to. No pressure. From Shadow Fox, got enough hats? Have some cash. Well, thank you very much. And I think I've looped back finally on things. Okay, that was the demo one. That was the voice one. I'm trying to make sure I get to everybody. If I missed you, I'm sorry. I'm a little incompetent at this, and my voice is starting to kill me. From Pirate Baron. What is your weeb opinion on Yakuza Like a Dragon? If you've ever tried the series with Zero or Kiwami, or Seven if you want an RPG, thanks for the endless hours of entertainment. I like the Yakuza series, actually, but I haven't had a chance to play all of them. I mean, I think there are like, what, let's see. Are there like 11 of them now? Right, because wasn't there one that you had to import from overseas, the man who lost his name or the man who had no name? Because for whatever reason, they didn't release it over here. It's kind of like Fatal Frame. Like, if you want to get a Fatal Frame game, they still make them. But you have to go to, like, Play Asia or somewhere else to, like, import them because they rarely show up. From Jazz, love you, Daddy Jim. Thank you very much. A message from Seams, but there's no message attached. From Mike, hey, Jim, what do you think of Praise in the Shadows? What do you think of the In Praise of Shadows situation? I used to watch the dude, then forgot about him until he made a few out of himself. In Praise of Shadows. Let me check this. It's not ringing a bell, so let me... Is that a YouTube channel? Oh, are you talking about the fucking guy? Is this the guy that went after Wendigoon and all of them? The one that was dressed up like... oh my god, he was dressed like a fucking character from... Not Rhinestone Cowboy. Midnight Cowboy? What's the one where the dude goes to New York to become a gay prostitute? And the jacket the guy wears, because he's like from Texas... It's the same fucking outfit this dude wore in his video where he was trying to shit on him when he had the sunglasses on. Is that the guy we're talking about? Oh, no, I've never watched his videos. Listen, I've watched a bunch of Wendigo stuff. I've watched Buckingham stuff. I've seen Mudahar stuff. I don't know what the attack was about. What is he going after them for? What have they done that's so reprehensible? I've said far worse in this one stream than I think all three of them combined have ever said in their entire careers. And he took massive umbrage with them. From Fake. Yo, what's up, folks? It's me, your boy, Ralph's son. Back at it again with the crib with my boys, the Cockroaches. Today we're reinforcing the crib with empty liquor bottles. From Corey K. Hey, Jimbo. Any advice for dealing with a very slow coworker? Had a grad start 6 months ago with multiple years of experience, but he knows nothing. Oh, is that somebody that bullshitted themselves on the resume? You sure they have the experience they're claiming to have? Because it sounds like they might be going slow because they don't know what the fuck's going on. Are they going to lock themselves in the server room and never come out? I hope nobody fucking calls them on anything. From Bunker Sauce, buy some smokes for your hats. Thanks for the entertainment over the years. Thank you. From Bold Knuckle, shout out to my fellow degenerates. Thanks, Jims, for the many years of laughter in these psychotic, clownish times. Okay, I'm going to go through a few more here. And then I'm going to go gargle salt water because my throat feels like it's going to die. Okay, let's see. I did that one. I'm trying to get through as many as I can here, so bear with me, folks. Another other man. I'm glad I made it in time with a pleasant evening with my dad, and it's nice to know those beatings I earned stopped me from being like these ones. Alert from the pain. From Astarte Kel, Thanks for keeping the internet a funny place, Jim. I bought hats for all three of my sons, so now I have a full sweetie squad at home. From Tech Walk, shout out to all the good dads like Jim. Tech Walk is offering 10% off custom builds for dads. TechWalk.org. I hope you got your $5 worth. AO Blue, happy Father's Day, Jim. Thanks for the laughs for all these years, and thank God you're not like these deadbeat dads. From Inoxus, why did Gamergate 2 happen? I thought you already saved the West. That's why Mount Gamermore was erected in your name specifically. Answer me now, Medicare. Yeah, that picture will forever haunt me. Oh, until something far gayer comes through. From Joker, hey Jim. My wife's Father's Day present to me was to take the kids out for a few hours right when the stream started. That way I can enjoy all the naughty words you say. Well, I hope you had a good time. Hope you were able to enjoy. And then I laid that heavy shit on you with the Thorpes. Oof. From Spidey, testing link, test. By the way, Jim, you sweaty 40k dork, you never answered my question. Who's my favorite Legion or faction? Yeah, I did, actually. If you go watch, I did a stream with Nick Riccata back in the day where we talked about this. From Andrew, would you care for a partially eaten sandwich, BB&J? Now, I think I'm going to pass on that. From DJ Ray, love you, Jim, no homo. From Sleep Paralysis Gremlin, I'll save Dad from having to whore himself out on eBay. Just bought 2 hats for my hat. Here's 100. Glad you finally have the means to support you, or support you, what? Or glad I finally have the means to support you since watching you. From Nyla Moon, here's a donation. Hope I can help, and happy Father's Day. Thank you very much. From Evma Alsar, get yourself a torta. Oof. Love me those tortas. From Big Boss, did you know Hulk Hogan will be in Minnesota this Tuesday to promote his beer line? No, I did not. The Hulkster has a beer line. Now it's recycling. It's going back to the Tit Beast hat one. It's like it's taunting me with that for some reason. From Nicholas Geisen, take your vitamin D, everybody. That's right, you take that vitamin D. From Steph O, thanks, Jim, for bringing families together. Hi, Ian, it's me, your mom. And I think I've caught up here. From Chilled Milk, Moon Cricketless on this hollow day. From Emperor Honkatine, hey, Jim, you dumb boomer, why haven't you marketed smaller versions of your hats that pin onto the full-sized hats? You could literally sell hats for your hats, and they will sell. You know, I probably could talk them into it. I could probably talk them into it. They'd think I was insane, but I could give it a shot. Oh, did my stream just die on me? My stream might have just died on me. Again, for the 18th fucking time. Hold on, folks. It says it's still live, so we should not be having an issue. Hopefully it didn't drop dead. OBS is showing me all green. It should be working just fine. Okay, now chat's moving. It looks like it's okay. All right, we're good. We're good. We're fine. Everything's fine. Oh, see what happens? Suddenly you bring up tiny hats. Okay, this guy was—he literally meant small hats for your hats. All right, it wasn't like some anti-Semitic dog whistle. He literally was talking about tiny hats. But you bring up tiny hats, and all of a sudden the live stream drops on you. I get it. I see what's going on here. All right, I don't understand. I thought I was gonna get like a Jewish deli platter, like the Keto Casino Boys. But no, you bring up tiny hats, suddenly the stream dies. Oigavalt. Yep. Coincidental timing. It's all a coincidence. Oy vey. He literally was talking about small ants, too. It's the best part. From Jeb Bush, thanks for all the laughs, Jeb. I'm glad you had a good laugh. From Hawksina, I'm going to buy a hat for my cat. Oh, well, we're really branching out now with this shit. From Snitch, Godspeed. From Ryan, hi, Jeb. Any update on the experimental treatments you spoke about a few streams back? God bless. They have no idea what the fuck's going on. I'm trying to get into... would it even matter if I mention it? Places like Cleveland Clinic or... what is it? UDN, which is through Mayo, Harvard, and like the health department. I don't know. It's a dark shit. I'll be honest with you. Let's not make the stream dark. Listen, we had darkness earlier on with Ben Thorpe, right? And then I think we're vibing pretty good. We're having a good laugh with Awesome Nader telling Mrs. Government what to do. Let's keep that energy at happy levels. All right, let's think of the tiny hats. Okay, keep the tiny hats in your hearts as we close this out. Okay, my voice is fucking... my throat is killing me. So I'm going to close this out. I can't... Somebody earlier mentioned Play It Out with a song, but I can't remember what song they mentioned. Chat, I've completely blanked on it. What song are we ending the stream on? I will let chat decide. Give me something good. Give me a bopper. Give me something. Give me something that Nicholas Fuentes would dance in a garbage bag to. Like, what are we ending on? What song are we ending the stream on? I see Rama Rama. Listen, we always do Rama Rama. I love Rama Rama. But we need something. We need something new. We need some new blood. It's just everybody saying Rama Rama. Oh, was that what it was? Backtraced it, or you done goofed it and remixed? Shit, I think that's right. Okay, hold on. Because I backtraced it, is that it? Or is it the You Done Goofed Mad Dad Only remix? Well, these are only like, I don't know which, they're like 30 seconds long. Are these, I can't end it on these. Let me try. Let's see what this sounds like. Hold on, let me put the volume on so you guys can hear this.
Okay, you guys, this is Jesse Sutter, and you know what? I just say that you guys have ruined my life.
I'm going to tell you right now. This is from...
Okay, you know what? Sure. Well, we'll end it on this. I'll let this play us out. Why not? And if it's too... Oh, yeah, you know what? That's fine. Put that up as a message. And then we'll play it out, yeah. But thank you for remembering what song it was. Yeah, I completely fucking blanked on what it was going to be. Thanks for sticking around. If I didn't get to your super chat, I really am sorry, but my voice is killing me. I try to get to them, but there's only so much I can do. Thanks for everybody that donated and bought a hat and a hat for your hat and tiny hats for those tiny hats that go onto those hats. We will call it a night. Hope you have a good rest of your Sunday, a good Father's Day. And we'll end it with the requested song earlier because I backtraced it remix, which I think this is the right one. There's like 10 of them, but they're all from 14 years ago, so I don't know which is the right one. So let's hope this is the right one. Have a good evening, chat, and I will see you later.
Okay, you guys, this is Jesse Sutter, and
you know what?
I just wanted to say that you guys have ruined my life.
I'm going to tell you right now. This is from her father. You bunch of my no good punks, and I know who it's coming from. Because I backtraced it, and you'll be reported to cyber police. Because I backtraced it. Consequences will never be the same day. Because I backtraced it, and you'll be reporting to cyber police. Because I backtraced it, you'll be arrested. End of conversation.
I am sure. I am literally having emotional breakdowns one after another.
Because I backtraced it, and you'll be reporting to cyber police. Because I backtraced it, consequences will never be the same. Because I backtraced it, and you'll be reporting to cyber police. Because I backtraced it, you'll be arrested. End of conversation. Because I backtraced it, and you'll be reporting to cyber police. Because I backtraced it. Consequences will never be the same. Because I backtraced it. And you'll be reported to cyber police. Because I backtraced it. You'll be arrested. End of conversation.
I am literally having emotional breakdowns one after another.
You will have to deal with the police. Because you...